Hi friends, welcome or welcome back to my channel. This is Esotero, and in today's Pick a Pup reading, we are going to be looking at what your November 2021 has in store for you and what spirit wants you to know about it. So we have four piles to choose from today, and understandably, because everyone of these piles and features something so adorable that it may be hard to choose. So I added stones as well. So if you have trouble picking based upon like the energies of the cards, I would pick based on the energy of the stone you feel most drawn to. But we have four piles to choose from today. So starting with pile one, we have the Cavalier King Charles Spaniel. And we have this hematoid quartz or fire quartz palm stone. And then for pile two, we have this boxer, and we also have this orange calcite palm stone. And then for pile three, we have this Akita, and we also have this Rhodonite palm stone. And then for pile four, we have this bearded collie and this smoky quartz palm stone. So go ahead and pause the video if you need to decide which pile you feel most drawn to. It's absolutely okay to be drawn to more than one. It's quite possible that you may have different messages in different piles that you need to hear. There's no right or wrong way to do these readings. So, you know, just pick what feels right to you, take what resonates, and throw away the rest. This is an example of a reading that actually isn't timeless, but I do want to say that if you are just scrolling around and looking for a reading, don't be afraid of when the video was uploaded. Trust that when readings come to you, they come to you for a reason. Now, obviously this one has a date in it. So, you know, November 2021. So obviously it's about that specific time frame, but the majority of my readings are timeless. And I did quickly want to mention that I'm going on a brief vacation. I'll be back in November, but I am going to be gone for just a hot sec. So if you need a reading, just know, and this is not just my channel, this is any channel, any tarot channel, if a video of theirs pops up, even if you've already seen it and you feel drawn to it, feel free to watch it again. Go to the beginning and see if you feel drawn to a different pile or the same one. I felt called to just give you that little tidbit of advice, but to also, I just wanted everyone to know that while these readings do technically have a time frame attached to them, the vast majority of my readings are timeless. So if you're needing some energy, there's plenty of content to fish through. And I would encourage you to look at readings you've looked at before and see if you're drawn to different piles, because it's cool to see how energy changes. Anyway, that's enough of me talking. Go ahead and scroll down to the description box or the comments section, where I will have all the timestamps listed for each pile below. And then once you have picked your pile, we will get into your reading. Hi there, pile one. Thank you so much for being here. If you chose the fire quartz stone and the Cavalier King Charles Spaniard. Shout out to anyone from Spain. This is going to be your reading. So let's go ahead and start with this card, because it is the Four of Hearts, which in the tarot is the Four of Cups. And I kind of shuffled these to, on the down low, represent your current energy. So with the Four of Cups being here, I definitely feel like you're ready for a change. You're probably kind of bored with life right now, or just kind of bored at where you're at in whatever cycle you're in. It kind of just seems like, it's not like life is insane or you're freaked out or you're frazzled, but at the same time, you're not really excited. You're not really like getting out of bed every day like, fuck yeah, it's a day and I'm gonna do it. Like, you're just like, eh. Everything kind of feels eh right now, which, you know, can sometimes be scary if it trickles into apathy, but I don't think it's at that apathetic level. If it is at that apathetic level, I would say right away, I would encourage you to seek some help or talk to somebody that really loves and cares about you, because apathy is a scary place to be in, man. But anyway, I definitely think you're ready for something new. You're ready for some kind of change. I think you're also kind of in this place of reflecting, but it's more so that, like, it's not like you're transitioning to a new cycle or something. It's just that, like, where you're at in your current cycle, you're low-key a little bit bored, but also it does seem like there are things that you're not seeing about this cycle yet that you need to know about. So I guess Spirit is going to talk about this for November. So I'm gonna pull four cards and then see what's on the back of the deck after the fourth card pops out. And I did want to mention, sometimes I do see people asking me, what does the back of the deck mean? And if I'm being honest, the back of the deck meaning kind of changes. But for the most part, it's usually like the all-encompassing energy, or like a main idea energy, or an energy that kind of summarizes things for me. You don't have to use it that way. I know some people use it as like a hidden aspect or something that's not being seen, or you know, something like that. But anyway, did I cut the deck into threes? I need to do that just in case. I don't think I did, and that will drive me crazy if I don't. You don't have to cut your deck into threes. I just it's just one of those things I picked up when I learned, and now I like doing it. So, okay, let's go ahead and see, Spirit. What can Pile 1 expect for the month of 2021? Month of November 2021. God, I wish 2021 were only a month. Okay, so to start, we have the Ten of Wands in reverse, and we have the Six of Pentacles in reverse. We also have the Eight of Swords upright. I just heard analysis paralysis. And finally, we have the World in reverse. And on the back of the deck, we have the Seven of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, you're definitely feeling a bit impatient, if I'm being honest. Okay, so let's go ahead. I'm going to lay out your oracles as well. So to start, we have Libra. We have Everything You Need Too Soon. We have Traveler. And we have Body as a House. Yeah. We also have the Mouse. We have Manifestation. We have Waxing Gibbous, Refine and Improve. We have Time. And finally, we have Inspiration. So I think I'm actually going to take this guy off the top and move this deck out of the way. I feel myself going really slow too. So I feel like you may be frustrated with your like productivity level at this time. Like you're just like, you want to get going, but you're having a really hard time getting yourself to get going, if that makes sense. Okay, I'm gonna put this card here and put this here. Okay, so yeah, these cards, let me make sure they're all in the frame. Okay, perfect. So let's talk about this month. These cards are definitely confirming what I was already feeling. But I actually think there's a lot of positive twists to come in the month of November. Now, in November, what I'm seeing here, and I'm glad the world came out in reverse, because this is confirming to me that this cycle is not over yet. In fact, I would say it's like maybe kind of halfway to like a quarter of the way through. And now this cycle could literally be anything. It could be like an emotional cycle you're in. It could be a cycle in your spiritual growth. It could be a cycle in like a business endeavor or something like that. It could be a cycle within school, within relationships. But the really honest, if I'm being honest, the most important relationship that you need to focus on in the month of November is going to be your relationship with yourself, which, oh wow, the tarot reader said you gotta like yourself and talk to yourself, oh no. Which, yeah, I know it sucks, but this Eight of Swords is the only card that came out upright, and I think this is exactly why you're feeling stuck. So with the Eight of Swords here, it says, I release myself from self-inflicted binds. And I think that what you have yet to realize, that you're going to be realizing this month, is that it's honestly impressive how much you've been able to accomplish despite only being half present. And by half present, I mean, like, it kind of only seems like you're half here right now. Like, you know, if you're hanging with friends, or you're at school or at work or whatever you're doing, it's like you're kind of there, but you're kind of off in your own little world as well. And I think that there's some frustration because it's like you're tired of the way your physical world is right now. But maybe you're also physically tired, you're also physically exhausted, or you're just kind of trying to get through things right now, or it seems like no matter what you attempt to do or what your intentions are to do, it's like it's hard to get your body to follow through with what your brain wants to do, it almost feels like, as well. And I think part of the reason why you've kind of been forced to hit the pause button is because you're very giving. You're incredibly giving. And Spirit is asking you to start giving to yourself, which of course is, like, once again, something very like, oh yeah, of course, we know we need to do that. But Spirit's saying, like, no, for real, like, you actually do need to give it to yourself. And I think you might be feeling really shitty because you might be feeling like, oh, I'm not doing enough, or I think I should be doing more, or I think that I could be getting more done. But you're not doing any of that. And what you're really doing is procrastinating, thinking about what you need to be doing, but you're not doing it. And you're under, and you believe, you're, and when you're not doing it, I should also add this, you're under the guise that you're resting. And this is not resting, because you're experiencing mental anguish. So when you take this time to rest, you never truly feel rested because you're spending all your time focused on what it is you need to do. And I think what it is that you need to do kind of overwhelms you. For some of you here, you could be very big picture people. Not everybody has to be, though. You may think that you're a big picture person just because you're overwhelmed by the small details, but the month of November is actually going to be about coming back down to earth, being present within yourself, and kind of getting out of this analysis paralysis you've been stuck in, and taking the reins back from your brain, because your brain is the one that has the reins of your life right now. And from what I can see here with manifestation and time, it's like manifestations, if you have had certain manifestations, it seems like they're starting to surface, but at the same time, you're recognizing that things need to change in order for these manifestations to come in the way you want them to, or for in order for them to manifest properly. And some of your manifestations may just may take a lot of time. Like, for example, if you're manifesting getting a doctorate, but you're only at your bachelor's, then, you know, obviously, like, you gotta manifest getting into a master's degree, you know, things like that. Obviously, that's just, like, one example, but I think what you're realizing is, like, the excitement of the manifestation has worn off, and now you're kind of waiting. But I think what you're not seeing is that manifestation is always a process of co-creation with Spirit. And think about it this way, you know, Spirit makes things happen from the spiritual realm, but they can't really manipulate the physical. That's why they need you. You need to be in charge of the physical requirements, and they can be in charge of the ethereal things, setting things up, putting thoughts in people's minds, you know, giving people the idea to do certain things. And so I think what Spirit has kind of been forcibly doing is cutting you off from source a little bit. And so if you came to this reading afraid that you're no longer connected to Spirit, or you've been having trouble connecting to Spirit the way you typically do, if you are spiritual at all, you certainly don't have to be, but that it doesn't have to be Spirit that you're connecting to, it can be, like, you know, yourself, or just kind of checking in with yourself, right? It seems like you're just very out of touch, with the world around you and what's going on, but it also feels like you're out of touch with the spiritual world or your own kind of dream world, honestly. And I think that has really freaked you out and kind of slowed you down. But this is not, spirit's not slowing you down because you're in trouble or you did something bad. Spirit's slowing you down because you need to slow down, essentially. I was trying to do things with my hands and I realized you couldn't even see my hands, so it wouldn't even make sense. But this mouse card talks all about looking into the small details, going within this, and this waxing gibbous, as it says, refine and improve. So in this month, I think you're going to be seeing where your manifestations are at and kind of connecting with spirit and seeing what is it that I need to do to keep these going along smoothly. What am I doing great? What do I need to let go of? And that's going to be different for every single one of you. But with this Libra card, I balance. I think there's a need to not do all of this alone. So Spirit is really saying in this month, don't be afraid to ask a partner for help. And when I say partner, this doesn't have to be a romantic partner, but that is a great source if you are in a romantic connection with somebody or have a partner. You know, you can ask them for their thoughts or just ask them to help you kind of, I feel like you need to get your thoughts out. You need to speak them. You need to write them so that you can objectively observe them because you're very analytical. And I think what you're not realizing is it's hard for you to get out of your own thought loops. And one thing I want to mention as well with this traveler card, one, you could be traveling in the month of November. It's a very obvious interpretation of that. But I think that this traveler card speaks more to your ability to leave your body. Like, you may be the type of person to have out of body experiences or struggle with like derealization or depersonalization. So if you struggle with that, it may be a good time this month to focus on, you know, strategies and solutions to help you be more present and asking for help if you don't have those resources. But also with this traveler card, you know, there's a lot of like Pisces energy here. Libra makes sense as well. With the world card, we have all the fixed signs. Taurus, Scorpio, Leo, and Aquarius. But with this traveler card here, it seems like, you know, the fantasy world in your head or your ability to kind of go into the 5D, the spirit world, your daydreams and meditations in the spirit world kind of all run into each other. And so it's kind of interesting because even when you're fantasizing, there's still a spiritual element to it, whether you acknowledge it or not. And I think what spirit is saying is that this month, there's going to be a need to face the fact that you may use this ability as a crutch to not face your reality. And that is actually what's stopping these manifestations from coming in. Because what I'm seeing is that you really need more root and sacral and solar plexus chakra energy. It definitely seems like you hang out in the higher chakras, so your throat, your third eye, your crown, but they kind of seem to be overactive. And I think what's freaking you out now is that you're kind of losing that connection. Not literally, you just think you're losing it. It's part of this fear. But spirit's kind of forcing this energy on you because spirit wants you to live the life that you want, the life that you're trying to manifest. And what you don't understand, or maybe it's not that you don't understand it, but maybe it's just that you haven't felt capable of facing it. Your comfortability and being in your dream world is the biggest thing that's actively stopping you from creating this life that you want. Because spirit's saying, yes, it is wonderful that you're connected to us, or yes, it is wonderful that you're connected to yourself. It is wonderful that you have big imaginations and big dreams, and that is often what is your source of inspiration. But I think spirit is saying, you're too comfortable there. And you've got all of the inspiration, you've got all of this stuff in spades, but But right now you might be feeling like you're losing it, or that it's going away, and that's not the case. It's just your own fears that it is. But spirit is kind of reducing that energy because they want you to ground. So one thing I will recommend straight off the bat is sound healing. Play like on your phone, like when you go to bed, like play some sound healing. And I think for you, some of the best ones I would recommend, like they're like lower chakra ones. So it'll include like the root, the sacral, and the solar plexus. I think that would be really wonderful for you, because I think one thing that spirit wants you to note as well is if a lot of these manifestations have to do with your creativity and productivity, spirit's really encouraging you to find inspiration in the physical world rather than in your own brain, because there's, or in the spirit world, because I don't really think you're feeling inspired from your brain, but I think you're feeling, it's just a lot of confusion and overwhelm. It's like for a second you feel okay, and then all of a sudden it takes almost nothing for you to be like, oh man, like I'm such a failure. I don't even know how I'm gonna get all this done. Or like, it's just worrying. I just keep hearing worrying. And so one thing that I'm hearing here is that spirit, part of spirit's goal in doing this is for you to recognize and see how your body is an extension of your soul. And the way that I want to use this, I'm thinking of Harper. So shout out to any Harpers out there, but I was thinking of the character Harper from Wizards of Waverly Place. If you've never seen that show, she's just like one of the main character's friends, and she always has these funky outfits. And you know, obviously they're not like something you'd buy straight off the rack, but they're her and they're creative and she loves them. And so I think that's a great example of how you can use your body as an extension of your soul, because that's what makes that, those outfits were what made her heart happy. That's how she liked to express herself. And so, you know, take an objective look at how you're treating your body and how you're treating yourself and your surroundings. And recognize that your body is just an ends to a means. Like the means being creating change, progress within the physical world. And that in order to exist within the physical world, you have to exist within a physical body. I think you're just very afraid of the physical world in general. And so the overall goal of this month is spirit is trying to get you to ground and find comfort in the physical world rather than detach and dissociate from the physical world, because that's not going to get you where you need to go. Because you developed, honestly, I don't even know if you developed these coping mechanisms. You could have developed them, but they could have just been your natural coping mechanisms that you've always had. And spirit's saying you've always had the spirit world to access, and you will always have the spirit world to access. But you're not in the spirit world. You're in the physical world. And we need you to be there. We need you to balance the spiritual and the physical. We need you to balance these energies. And I think one thing that spirit is saying is part of this is not them slowing anything down. It's you slowing your manifestations down, because you're very afraid of what you've already cultivated as a result of your manifestations. With everything you need to soon, it's like, oh my God, like getting what I want is really scary, you know? Being responsible for myself and seeing what I can actually do is really scary. And I think you need to start trusting yourself. And I think also, if you've come a long way, I don't think you give you or spirit nearly enough credit for how far you've come and how much that they've told you that's turned out to be correct. So I would highly encourage you to look back at all the things that spirit has told you in the past. If you have journals or anything like that, just look at how far you've come. And look at where you're at. Another message that I do want to give everybody is, if you're seeing someone right now, it does look like things could be heading to a level of commitment, or a higher level of commitment if you're already with somebody. You could be meeting someone special this month. But I think this balance has more so to do with the fact that you're just observing everything and you're not really doing anything. Because, you know, Libra is air energy, and we have this Eight of Swords here, and we have four swords on both sides. And, you know, I think you lend four of those swords to fearing about the fact, like, what if this is supposed to be what I'm doing? What if I'm messing everything up? What if, like, you know, all of your spiritual fears, and then the other swords cover all of your earthly material fears. And so you're seeing both sides of things, but you're not taking any decisive action or really doing anything. And so I think one thing that you need to do is ask for help. You're so giving to other people, and there are people in your life that are willing to help you if you ask. So please do ask them. Another thing that you need to know is that there's a need to be patient and also trust that you're going in the right direction, even if you can't see the final destination. You just need to look at the horizon. You know, that's all you need to be doing. And with the Ten of Wands in reverse, you know, upright, it says, I love and care for myself first. And so I think what this month is going to be all about is getting you out of this limbo bored state. But what you need to understand about this is that there is no person or event or achievement or thing that is going to change this energy for you. You are the only person that can change this energy, because what is happening to you is just objectively happening. It's however you perceive it. And so what Spirit is saying is we're slowing things down on purpose because we don't want you to perceive things in a way that scares you or makes you think that you're not doing something correctly. You're in your head right now. You're not in a place to be. You're not thinking clearly about where your attention is needed to be directed in the present and where it needs to be headed in the near future. Not 10 years in the future, I mean like in the next few months. But I do think that with this energy kind of forcing you to get out of your head, you're gonna have so much creative inspiration. And I think that by the end of this month, you're going to feel a lot more relief. At least I hope so. The one thing I will say, though, is that this energy will last as long as you allow it to last. So if you don't change anything, you might be coming to my December predictions video being like, this is exactly like last month. And Spirit's going to say, that's not anybody's fault but yours. Okay? And I don't mean that in like a shitty way. Like, it's all your fault. It's just, it's really hard to recognize how our brain distorts things sometimes. And you have to remember that your brain is the only thing that keeps you connected to your outside reality. Like, that's it. So however your brain sees things, that's your reality. And so that's why it's so important to be making sure that you are using your brain wisely instead of allowing your brain to use you. So with this mouse card, I think that this month for you, in order to have the most successful month, it's like there's a need to slow down, ground, be present, and also just kind of take things in, see where you've been, and recognize that you can't wish this journey away. This journey is going to happen the way it's going to happen. And Spirit just wants you to find peace in your present rather than feeling like you need to be focused solely on what's next. I think part of the problem too is that you haven't truly let go of some of your manifestations yet. Like, you see them, you know that they're there, but I think you just doubt yourself. It's all your mentality, if I'm gonna be honest. Like, the month in November is going to go however your mentality is. So if you have a bad mentality, if you have a bad attitude and you think everything sucks and nothing's going to get better, then your month is going to suck and nothing's going to get better. But if you have the attitude of, you know, there might be challenges, it being present in the physical world is scary, but I'm going to challenge myself to do it, or I'm going to challenge myself to try something new or to change what I'm doing. I recognize XYZ that's not working currently, and I'm going to come up with solutions to change it. Or just being optimistic that even if you don't know how to figure things out, Spirit will help you and help you find solutions, and that finding solutions is a process of trial and error. So don't get discouraged if the first solution you come up with isn't the solution that helps, you know? There's just a willingness to be open and to be patient with yourself. This refining and improving is all about seeing what works and what doesn't, holding on to what works, discarding what doesn't, and changing things up to see how you can make things in your life work more. So, is there anything else you want to say to pile one spirit? The only thing that spirit is saying is that you are your own best friend or your own worst enemy, and you have to be present or be cognizant of the fact that, or not cognizant of the fact, you need to be cognizant of how you're acting towards yourself. You know, when you think mean thoughts about yourself, would your inner best friend say that to you? Like, no. And maybe it would be helpful, like, if you have a best friend or somebody that you really care about that makes you feel good. If they're unavailable or you're unable to directly speak to them, a great way to understand an inner best friend is to say, like, well, what would that person say to me, or what would they think, you know, because they care about you and they care about your best interests. So I'm going to shuffle from the personal power deck and get you some more advice and just see what spirit wants you to do this month. Give these another good shuffle. So spirit, how can pile one be more empowered in the month of November? I am confident. Yeah, be confident in your abilities. That's one thing I feel like I need to say to you, by the way. I feel like that's what I've been missing, is like, you really have done so much. You've come so far. Like, you're doing amazing. It's literally your perception that you're not. And spirit's saying, like, we're slowing you down, not because you don't deserve your manifestations, or not because this isn't right for you. We're slowing you down because there's things that need your attention and you're not paying attention to them. And in order for this to manifest in the correct way, we need you to slow down, focus on those, refine and improve that, so that this can come in a way that flows to you. And I think one thing that you need to be confident in is your ability to regulate yourself. And so if you don't know how to regulate yourself, that is your homework for the month of November. And if you don't know how to regulate yourself, I mean, obviously, sources, Google, learn about yourself. There's so many different people coming to this reading. So, like, regulating yourself, what works for you may not work for somebody else. So I'm not going to just, that's going to be something like, if, listen, I can lead you to the toilet, but I can't wipe your ass for you. That is the point of tarot readings. Like, and that's the same way as spirit. Like, they can lead you to the toilet, but they can't wipe your ass for you. Like, you got to wipe your own ass. You got to be confident in your ability to wipe your own ass. So the point is, be confident in your ability to take action. This month is all about action. Don't get stuck in your head. What else, spirit? How else can they be empowered? I am celebrated. Celebrate yourself. And that's what this world card is all about too. Maybe even though nothing is super, super exciting is happening this month for you, or nothing that worth celebrating is going on, then get a hold of the people that you love and find an excuse to celebrate, or celebrate the fact that you exist, or that you've been existing for this long and you're doing okay. Like, there's always something to celebrate, even if it's super small. Like, I celebrate on cloudy days because the sun is super intense and I'm just like, she's just so much. And I love her, but like 93 million miles away and she's still a bit too close for me. So I just enjoy those clouds. I enjoy a little bit of distance, and I celebrate that. So, like, anything that you need an excuse to celebrate for it. I am forgiving. So, yeah, I think also, like, you need to forgive yourself for these periods of analysis paralysis, or these periods of kind of detaching from your reality. Because what you need to understand is that it is a coping mechanism. You're coping with whatever that you're dealing with. And it's not a very healthy coping mechanism, but shaming yourself for having that coping mechanism is not going to help you in any way, shape, or form. So be forgiving to yourself, because it's so unfair to you to, like, have these expectations that you're always going to be on your game. Like, sometimes you're going to need a break. Sometimes you're gonna fall into old habits and old patterns, that's okay. You just need to get back up and keep going. When those happen, when those setbacks happen, that doesn't mean you throw in the towel and give up. It just means you recognize that there was a setback. See why that setback happened. What can you do to change that setback? Or what can you do to prevent that setback from happening if you can? And if there's nothing you could have done to prevent that setback, then recognize that it's out of your control and that you can't be cruel to yourself for something that was meant to happen. And we have, I am unbreakable. So Spirit is saying, exactly, like, you can have setbacks, but you're not a quitter and you're not going to give up. And so I think, you know, what you need to know for this month is that you've got this. You're great. I think all you need to do is recognize that your brain is a part of you. It is not all of you and it is not your truth, but that you need to observe your brain as a functioning piece of yourself that operate, like, it's an operating system, and you need to understand how it operates, and you need to understand, like, you need to be able to see beyond it and see what it's telling you so that you can be mindful of when your mind is keeping you in these self-inflicted binds, and you can keep going and improving. You're gonna be just fine, honestly. You know, just trust yourself to make the decisions that you need to. I think really, There's nothing to worry about. There really is. You're safe. You're fine. And I think that's why grounding will be so effective for you, is I think you need to feel just like the kind, calm, loving energy in nature. Like, nature has such a loving and peaceful energy to it. And I think that you need to just experience that stillness. Because the ironic thing is, while everything in your physical present may seem still, your mind is racing a mile a minute. So you haven't slowed down at all. It just seems like things have slowed down on the outside, but not on the inside. Okay, so we're going to finish off with a gratitude message. I think the theme of the month is going to be gratitude. So Spirit, what does Pile 1 have to be grateful for that you want them to be grateful for in this month? Okay, so we got an inspiration card, and inspiration twice. So I think hopefully at the very least this month will give you a lot of creative inspiration. Yeah, step outside of your routine today, enjoy the freedom it brings. And there's a quote by Mary Oliver, and it says, tell me, what is it you plan to do with your one wild and precious life? So yeah, I think Spirit is saying, a lot of what's holding you back is your own self-limiting beliefs, and it's time to change things up, especially if things aren't working, and make November more exciting or more functional or more relaxed. Put less pressure on yourself. Enjoy the freedom of just trying different things. Things don't need to work. But clearly what you're doing now isn't working. So let's try. I think Spirit is saying it's time to just try some new things and step outside. I don't think this is just about your routine. I think it's also about stepping outside of your comfort zone and not being afraid to look at the things that need to be addressed and looking at those little details. And if you're afraid to look at them, ask someone for help. So Pile 1, I'm going to leave your reading here. Thank you guys so, so, so much for watching. Definitely feel free to let me know how this resonates in the comments. I also wanted to say thank you so much to everyone who watches my ads. That is the simplest and easiest way to support me. But if you're interested in supporting me in other ways, you can check out my merch. You can check out a reading with an extended on it. You can check out my social media. Or you can subscribe to my channel, you can like this video, you can comment, let me know how it resonates. But by no means, you're not required to do anything. I am wishing all of my Scorpios and all of my November Sagittarians a very happy, happy birthday. I hope everybody has a wonderful month of November, and happy Thanksgiving to all of my, I believe only people in the US, because my Canadians already celebrated Thanksgiving, if I'm being correct, but us Americans have Thanksgiving. So happy Thanksgiving. I hope you all have a wonderful day or night whenever it is that you're watching this video, and I hope you'll come back and see me again soon. Bye. Hi there, pile two. If you guys chose the orange calcite and the boxer, this is going to be your reading. Now I have to mention I'm redoing your intro because I messed it up and I accidentally knocked this card over and spirit told me to take it. So this card, I don't even know what it is yet, but this card is going to be your first card for the month of November. Spirit just didn't want me to, I don't know, it's very important. We'll see why in a little bit, but I was talking to spirit and I was like, you know what, it's early enough, let me just restart the whole thing. But I'm gonna move this off to the side for a second, as we will shuffle that. But I want to talk about the card that you picked first, the boxer. And one thing that I just noticed is, you know, the boxer is like looking up at the sky, at the stars. And the card representing it is the Jack of Cups. And so the way this would translate to tarot, I don't know if people use jacks to represent pages or knights or both, but it would definitely, it would be a page or knight of cups. So you could be, one thing that I'm feeling, I've been taking this card to kind of represent your current energy when you come to the reading. And so I do feel like the biggest thing happening for you overall is you're deepening your connection to the universe. And I almost feel like you're looking up at the stars in a different way than you used to, or you're looking up with hope. Like this has almost star energy, like the star, you know, it's almost like you're looking at life with maybe hope again, but it's like a cautious hope. It's like maybe, but I don't know if I like trust anything like this. You're uncertain of yourself, but at the same time, I think you're really excited to feel excited again, or to feel whatever you're feeling right now, which I would say is maybe hope or joy or optimism or infatuation. This can also talk about like romantic connections. So you could be feeling extra connected to your partner, or you could just be feeling, you could be seeing somebody, or you could just be feeling extra loved from your family. One interesting thing about this is a childhood friend of mine that I used to know had a boxer named Noodles, and she was a good dog, and I don't know what Noodles is doing now. I hope she's vibing out in the astral, but shout out to dogs. They're just awesome. And I was just thinking, if anybody had a pet that passed on recently, I felt called to say that they wanted you to know that they're doing okay and that they love you and that they've been sending you signs that they're around. So if you've had any feelings like they've been sending you their presence, I think that is correct. And if you haven't gotten any signs, ask for some, or just stay open, because I think you'll find them. But let's go ahead and see what's this card that spirit is so... Okay, we have the Queen of Swords in reverse coming out. So what else then, Spirit? What else can Pile 2 expect for the month of November 2021? We have Temperance in reverse. We have Death upright. I let go and embrace new beginnings. Okay. These are connected. So we have the Five of Cups in reverse and the Three of Swords upright. And on the back of the deck, we have the Knight, not the Knight, the Nine of Swords in reverse. Okay. Well, this is really interesting. Shout out to my Scorpios in here. Y'all got a birthdays coming up. Uh-huh. Okay, this makes sense with the Fool. And then... okay. This makes sense. Gotcha. Okay. So, let's go ahead and look at your oracles now. I'm probably gonna have a hard time fitting them all in here, but that's okay. So, to start, we have the 12th house, Escape. We have Volcano in reverse. We have Observer upright, Look at how similar those two are. Oh my gosh. This Boxer and the Observer. We also have Make It Look Like the Night. Excuse me. We also have Dog. So you're getting double dogs. We have Humility. We have, this is a rune card and it says Wunjo. I'm probably saying that wrong, but it represents joy and harmony and Leo energy, but it came out in reverse and I'll explain why. We also have the Magician. And finally, we have number three, Nurturing. And this is the Earth Star Chakra, but I think that's a mouthful. So I just say the Mega Root Chakra because it's like an amplified root chakra almost. I like to say the Mega Root. So we also have this Nurturing card coming through. I'm just gonna place that there so that this is all in the frame. So, okay. Yeah, the month of November, I will say you're definitely gonna be, it's kind of interesting. In the month of November, I think you're gonna be like more in tune with the universe than you have been in the past. But one thing that I'm seeing here is there may be a fear of change or a fear of life. And when I say fear of life, I'm like, there's a fear of the unknown for sure. And I think it's something that while you're afraid of, you still have been, doing the things, doing life. You may have gone through an ego death recently for some of you, not all of you, because that's intense. But for some of you, I can definitely see that you went through an ego death recently. And as a result, it's creating a literal death of like, things are changing, things are growing. But this month is also going to be challenging you to get out of old perceptions. I'm definitely my process of channeling with this pile is a lot slower. And I think it's that Pisces energy. Because one thing that I'm seeing here is that like everything that's been happening in your life has occurred the way it's meant to. With this Temperance in reverse here, I find clarity through calm. I think calm freaks you out. And so I think that actually there might be a lot of craziness in your life, or there has been a lot of craziness in your life, but you're finding clarity through the reflection once you get through the craziness. And I think that's a system that works for you. And I think that you shouldn't feel like you have to change how you find calm, find clarity, if it works for you. But one thing that I'm seeing here is there's new beginnings coming for you in this month. And for some of you, absolutely nothing in your physical world is changing. It's all about your perception of the world. Like, you see things in a different way. You wake up with a different attitude. You see life in a different way. Maybe for some of you, you could have had a near-death experience recently that really shook you up as well. Another random message that I feel called to say is that for some of you, you may be seeing someone that you care about. Like, you might be visiting someone in prison. You may be like visiting them in some way or seeing them. That's just something that I saw here. But there's a lot of healing that is going to occur in this month because you're getting ready to embrace this new beginning. You're in the, so this makes sense. You're this month, in the month of November, you're in the process of letting go and transitioning into the end of November, beginning of December. You're learning to embrace this new beginning because this death is kind of still happening. So I think that you've maybe either recently gotten into spirituality or you know, you're hitting a spiritual high, or like you're just experiencing a lot of new spiritual phenomena that you have not before. And I think as a result, it's really shooken you up, because with this Queen of Swords in reverse, the things that matter to you, that matter to you, you're realizing are not as important as you thought they were, or that's not what I truly want, or that's not what truly matters to me, because I think what you were protecting were ego desires. And whatever this ego death was, or this change in attitude, it doesn't even have to be an ego death. It could just be a change of attitude, or the ability to hear and see what your soul is saying. You're realizing that what you thought was important, what you needed to protect, was not actually as important as you realized. And this energy has brought you back into this childlike sense of wonder again, where you're rethinking everything. And this is wonderful. And actually, it's not really rethinking. It's more so the fact that you're learning to turn your brain off and allow yourself to experience things. You may be getting more into the occult with the 12th house here. You could be having crazier dreams. You could be having a lot of deja vu this month. It definitely seems like your spiritual awareness and your spiritual gifts are going to be heightening, or your spiritual abilities, if you don't think you have a gift, are going to be heightening. But one thing that Spirit wants you to be aware of is that this month may feel a little isolating. But if you've already been feeling this isolating thing, I think that's coming to an end. But this isolating feeling is important, because I think, well, let's talk about why you're going to be isolated. You're going to feel isolated because you're going to be seeing things differently than most people do. And you're not really going to be able to explain it, because there are things that you just have to experience. And even if you explain them to other people, they wouldn't be able to empathize. You know what I mean? And you may try to explain what you're going through to people, and they won't be able to empathize. And maybe that's how you'll recognize that you're feeling isolated. But this isolation is not something that will be cured by just being around buds. You are going to feel isolated around anybody that can't connect to you at the same level you're operating at this month. That doesn't mean forever. It just means this month. This month you're going to feel more isolated, and this month you're going to struggle more. But there's something very important about this, because for some of you, there's somebody from your, I hate saying this. I'm saying this for those people who know it to be true. Everyone else, disregard this message. There could be somebody coming in from your past, or maybe you're already communicating with them, or you know that like there might be a new beginning there. And if that's the case, you may be able to see this person or this situation in a light that you didn't see before, which kind of forces you to see things differently. And it might be disappointing to realize like maybe how your perception was distorting things. But for everyone else, there could be people coming in, or you could be connecting with people you already know in a different way, in a more authentic way, because you're aligning with them in a more soulful way. And one thing that I think here is that a challenge that you're going to face within all of this is you're going to feel like you're outside of life rather than participating in it. And there will be times during this month where you do need to be an active participant and not just an observer. So, for example, we have the Magician here. And I do think an important manifestation is coming to fruition this month. And I think this manifestation has brought about this change. And so one thing that Spirit wants you to be aware of is now that these things that you've been manifesting or these things that you've been trying to create are coming into your present, you have to exist within them. You have to interact with them. You can't just observe them. And it will feel a lot more comfortable for you to kind of stay like on the perimeter of life and just kind of observe like a fly on the wall. But spirit is kind of challenging you to be open to what the month of November has to offer you, because it does seem like there's a lot of exciting experiences that may come your way, or opportunities. And with the dog card here and the nurturing card here, I think that you're going to be either feeling loved by the people around you in your life and feeling connected and supported with them, or if there's somebody that you connect with on a spiritual level, whether it's a platonic friend, whether it's a family member or a romantic interest or romantic partner, I think that this month is going to be allowing you both to connect in the physical world in a spiritual way. So while you may naturally connect with this person on a 5D level or on the astral, spirit is saying, we're trying to bring this into the 3D. We're trying to give you the opportunity to experience what a spiritual connection is like on the physical plane and what that seems like. And I think it will humble you in a lot of ways. And I think you'll learn a lot more about what you've already healed and recognize how your ego or how your perception of things was distorting the truth of the situation. And I think that one thing that you're going to have to do this month is find the balance between detaching from reality to create the outcomes and be the magician, create the outcomes you want and be the magician, but also to know once that those outcomes or once those situations have been created, then to kind of step back in, be present and interact with it. Because one thing that I'm seeing here with joy and harmony is I think you may be afraid that you're never going to feel true joy or true happiness or be present in the moment. For some of you, this feeling of being out on the periphery is something that you often feel or always feel. And so you're being challenged this month to put that to an end. But for others, this is a newer sensation for you. And this sensation is important because one, it's going to help you connect with the people that have always felt like they're out on the perimeter. And two, it's going to help you see what you haven't seen before because you've only been looking at things from your point of view. So whichever is your case, that's fine. But there may be opportunities this month to let loose and let go, or to be honest about things, or to be vulnerable. And I think spirit is asking you to trust yourself that you are safe and that you can protect yourself, and to trust those intuitive feelings you have rather than what you think you should know or what feels right. Because I think the earth is going to be very nurturing to you this month. So if you need some confidence, I would definitely take some time to ground. But I think what you're realizing in this month is that you're never going to fully enjoy life if you're on the outside or you're pushing away any positive experiences that come your way, because you may have been under the belief for a long time that happiness isn't something that you deserve, or that enjoying the moment isn't something that is for you, or that things will never get better. And I think you're realizing that your belief that things would never get better was a belief. And I think that you're seeing now that there's always room for change. There's always room for growth. There's always room for improvement. And there's always something we're not seeing, you know. As humans, we're all dumbasses. Like, we're all so dumb, and we all think that we're smart, and we're not. We're all dumb, and like, we're all just doing the best we can. And so I think recognizing that, you know, not beating yourself up for what you believe to be true and remaining open-minded will help you stay open to all the options available to you and find the ones that will make you the happiest or fit you the best. But I definitely think that in this month, you could be really exploring your spiritual side. There might be some weird shit happening. Spiritual connections may be coming in, new ones or pre-existing ones. But I think more than anything, kind of similar to pile, this energy isn't similar to pile one. Actually, interestingly, it's almost like you and pile one are in completely opposite energies, or like transitioning into opposite energies. But you both are similar in the sense that this month will be what you make of it. How much you let go of your past, your old patterns, your old beliefs, and you embrace the new, embrace being open to different experiences, and just allow yourself to be on this kind of crazy ride, because I do feel like there will be a bit of chaos in the month of November, but it's nothing you can't handle. In fact, I think a lot of you kind of thrive in chaos, but what you're maybe not realizing in the midst of the chaos is that you're still growing, you're still evolving, and you're still learning. And I think what you're going to realize this month is your most impactful learning experiences, or your most impactful experiences that aid your spiritual growth, are experiences that don't happen in the moment, but are a culmination of experiences that help you reflect afterwards. You know, hindsight is 2020. And I think for you, a lot of your ability to grow and evolve is like dependent on your ability to see things differently, be open to different things, to challenge yourself to not stick to a certain narrative. I think that what you need to know about the month of November is that you don't need to know anything, and that's okay. But you can be optimistic towards what's to come and recognize that everything that's happening right now is for your own spiritual growth. But the interesting thing, what I really think is coming, is this Fool card, is this new beginning. And I think that this is going to be something that starts in November, not November, December to like January, maybe November, the end of November, I would say, if that's the case. But it's like, you know, the 12th house is Pisces energy, and then it transitions into the first house, which is Aries energy. And, you know, I see Aries in the Fool as well. And so I think that you're kind of tying up loose ends this month. You're getting ready for change. You're being humbled by the universe to recognize that maybe you don't know what's best for yourself, and maybe the universe does. And that maybe just by being open to what the universe wants to show you, you'll figure out exactly where you need to go and find out exactly who you are by just being willing to participate in what spirit is throwing your way, rather than feeling the need to control everything. Let go of the need to control. Let go of the need to know what is going to happen next. You don't need to know. You just need to know that you're supported, that you're safe, that you're loved, and that you only need to be focused on the next couple steps ahead. But I do, there is a warning here from Spirit with this Three of Swords here, not to allow past pain to keep you stuck in a cycle of wounding yourself. Because with the Five of Cups here, I will move forward when the time is right. I think you've been ready. I think you have moved forward from a lot. You have grown from a lot. But with this Three of Swords here, it's like you think about something, your brain's like, hey, we haven't thought about this heart-wrenching thing that happened to us. Or, hey, we haven't thought about how we fucked this up in a while. And with this, I see things exactly as they are. It's like, are you really seeing things exactly as they are? Or are you seeing things exactly as they were to you in that present moment? Because Spirit might be bringing people or experiences, and when I say people or experiences, they could be the same people or similar experiences, or different people and different experiences with the same underlying energies at play. So whatever it will be is going to be different for all of you, but Spirit is challenging, is recreating these cycles for you to not see things as they are to you, but to instead see them as they are objectively, and see them as they are outside of your perceptions and limiting beliefs. Spirit is challenging you to not see things as they are to you, but to see things as they are, as Spirit presents them, and be observant. Observe, and that's the difference. It's like observing rather than judging. Observing your experiences when you feel good or bad emotions, observing that you're feeling those things rather than placing a judgment on whether that's good or bad. and but instead just making room for all of these experiences. Your ego wants to know everything. Your ego wants to know it's right. And that's really common. Like, you know, and it's a way to help us feel safe. And so I think what you need to realize is the safest bet for you is to know that you know nothing and to be open to what the world and spirit has to show you and trust that you have a good enough relationship with yourself to make the decisions that are going to be best for you and trust that even if things don't go exactly the way they're planned, the ends will justify the means. There's a need to let go of things happening a certain way or have a certain idea about them, and instead just be open to the energies at present and capitalize on those energies, you know, take advantage of those energies. I think that this time, this month, is going to be a great month for you to go within. And so if you need to take time away from the world to just kind of figure out what you need and be kind of in your own energy, you can. There's almost a need to nurture your inner child. So maybe a lot of this nurturing isn't even coming from anyone else, but it's spending time with yourself, spending time with Mother Earth, and like taking time to nurture that inner child, that part of yourself that's wounded, so that you can look at the world with maybe some more excitement or childlike wonder rather than fear of how things will blow up in your face or fear of how things will end poorly. I think maybe what you're realizing is that you create some self-fulfilling prophecies because of negativity or fears or trauma or things like that. And so if it's not something that you can regulate on your own, I think spirit is really encouraging you to seek out help to regulate that. So let's go ahead and get some affirmations for this month and see. I cut the deck and we have I trust my intuition. So I think that's one of the biggest things. And I think that's why too, spirit's being so vague about what's going on here is because this month is really about you trusting yourself and trusting your intuition and recognizing that any outside help is there to support you, but it's not there to do the work for you. So, Spirit, what affirmations should Pile 2 tell themselves in the month of November to be as successful as they can possibly be? I follow my heart. Yes, exactly. This is perfect. You need to be focused on what you can't see. You need to, like, honestly, and actually, I think I should just talk about this. There's also Libra energy here. So, if there is anything love-related in this month, what you need to know is don't judge, especially if this is a past person, don't judge them based on their past. Don't judge them based on preconceived notions. Allow this person to show up in any way they want to. Allow them to be instead of expecting them to be or do something. And just follow what feels right to you. You know, there's a lot of like flaws in a very common like idea of I only believe what I can see with my own two eyes. Well, does that mean that you don't believe in like carbon monoxide detectors? Because you can't see that shit, but it'll fucking kill you. You know, like there's a lot of shit that we literally can't see with our own two eyes that objectively exists because we can measure it. We just can't see it. And so I think what spirit is challenging you to do is to not rely on what you can see, because you think you see things exactly as they are, but you're not seeing them exactly as they are, because seeing is just one way of perceiving things. You also have feelings. You also have hearing. You also have taste. You have so many senses, and humans, we just rely on our eyesight for a lot. And as a result, we rely less on our other senses. And so for people who don't have eyesight, obviously they're, or not great eyesight, then they rely on their other senses more to take in and process and understand the stimuli that is happening around them. And so I think what spirit is challenging you to do this month is instead of seeing things as they are, ask yourself how you feel about them. How does that feel to you? If it doesn't feel good, how can we change that? But I also think that there's a need to be vulnerable here and to be optimistic and be willing to be open. I think that your fears of the past keep you closed off from being more vulnerable. And I think what you need to realize is that you're safe. And we have trust in divine timing. I trust in divine timing. So Spirit is saying that a lot of this is coming in, like, you're exactly where you need to be in the exact moment. And like, even with this rose here, like, it's happening for you, not to you. And I think what you're going to realize by the end of this month is that a lot of the things that happened in this month were happening for you, not to you. We also have I am abundant. And so I think Spirit is also challenging you to see what you already have and how much you already do have. Because the 12th house is the last house in the zodiac. And I think that you are finishing like a cycle. Especially with death coming in here, like, you are closing out a cycle. And I think that you've grown a lot and you've learned a hell of a lot. And so I think this also has Taurus energy attached to it. So maybe spending time just appreciating what you've already accumulated, or maybe treating yourself a little bit would be something good to do as well. But remember that you know, money is just a tool, and it is just a way to create what we want. And it's not everything. You are so much more important than anything else. And finally, we have I surrender. And I think that this is perfect. This I surrender card is exactly what you need. And look, it literally looks like you're surrendering this fear. You're surrendering seeing things as they are. I think Spirit is really asking you this month to surrender to what you don't know. And surrender to what will be. Surrender to the flow. Surrender to, like, not feeling like you need to be in control. And on the back of the deck, we have I am hopeful. And this is perfect, because that's the total vibe that I got, was like, yeah, I'm hopeful. And underneath that, we have I am a dreamer, more Pisces energy. So, like, Spirit is saying, you know, your ego keeps you safe, but it also holds you back. It keeps you safe by keeping you stuck in the same habits and cycles. And when you are able to see beyond your ego and recognize that it's just a mechanism trying to protect you rather than your truth, it frees you up to really figure out what truly does mean the world to you and what it is you truly do want. And why you're really here, you know? There is no amount of money, cards, sexual partners, people, like, nothing will fulfill us if we are constantly, like, not, like, if you can't be present now, if you can't find peace in your current reality, you will not find it in any other reality, I guess is my point. But we're going to finish off with some final advice for you this month. And these cards are all about gratitude. So I challenge all of you to practice gratitude this month. If that's just like thinking of three things that you're grateful for every day or something like that, do it. But Spirit, what advice do you have for pile two, please? Okay, so we have an affirmation here, and it says, wherever you are, look around. Notice things in your environment that soothe, inspire, or help you. And we have a quote by Robert Frost, and it says, we love the things we love for what they are. And I think that is so true. Because anything that your heart truly wants to follow, you'll love it. You'll want it for what it is, not for what it could be, not for its potential, not for what it may be. And I think with this I am abundant, I think if you are more present in your, in like in your, if you're being, if you're in your solitude, for example, like going through the things in your house that soothe you, inspire, or help you, can not only help you feel more grounded, but help you feel more nurtured and more connected to the universe. But also, I think that you'll also be able to notice things that distract you or demotivate you or don't help you. And you can also eliminate those. You know what I mean? So pile two, Spirit wants me to look at the back of the deck. Okay. Wow. Okay, I see why. So we have another affirmation card, and there's a Lord Byron quote, and it says, "There is pleasure in the pathless woods." And it says, "Spend some time thinking about a part of your life that is yet to be planned out. Remind yourself that to have an adventure ahead is a gift, and your life is full of possibility." Yeah, I think this is so true. You know, instead of wondering, "Oh God, what's gonna happen?" Think, "I can't wait to see what's gonna happen," or "I'm really open to seeing what's gonna happen today." Or, "No matter what happens, I'm open to the possibilities, and I trust that whatever I encounter, I will be able to overcome those challenges." You know, optimism really goes a long way. You want to approach life the same way a happy dog does, you know, just, God, so fucking excited for everything, even if it's small. Like, you know, it's a beautiful, beautiful energy to be in. And so I definitely think spending some time with dogs this month could also help you kind of get into that loving energy. But I think you just need to be kinder to yourself this month. And instead of seeing yourself as soft for following your heart or what your soul wants you to say, see yourself as hard, man. Like, I'm not gonna lie, it's hard as fuck to follow your heart, to be vulnerable, to be open. Like, you know what makes you a pussy? Playing it cool, pretending like you don't care about anything, saying everything is lame. You know what's really cringy? Being worried about being cringe. I'm happy about being, like, you know, to be cringe is to be free. Like, to be vulnerable. Like, spirit is saying, while your ego thinks it's protecting you, it's really caging you in to behave in a way where you think you'll be accepted. And that's fucking stupid. It's bullshit. And I'm cussing a lot, but honestly, I'm being authentic to myself, and I don't give a fuck if anyone's offended by it, because it's my goddamn channel. And if you have a problem, you can go somewhere else. And I think that's what you need to understand as well. You can surrender to being you and recognize that any negative interpretations of your energy is on those people. And that, in fact, you don't owe anyone shit, but you do owe yourself the blessing. I don't know what to call it, a blessing, a gift, you deserve to hear yourself out, all parts of yourself, not just the logical ones. There's so many parts to you, and you need to see yourself as multidimensional, not just as a culmination of negative events that have hurt you. That's not an identity. That's just things that have happened to you that have wounded you. And now you're so much more than that, essentially. There's so much more than your pain. There's so much more to life than avoiding pain. Pain is unavoidable. You're going to feel pain anyway. Like, even just walking, you may stub your toe. You know what I mean? Pain is just a part of life. But that doesn't mean it's not worth living. And I think the more you have confidence in this, in your ability to trust yourself and recognize that it's okay not to know what's next, it's okay to make mistakes, it's okay to just be open and see what happens instead of pushing things away and feeling like you can't be happy, because that's not true. And the question marks in front of you should not make you fear the unknown. They should make you excited for what the unknown has in store for you. So for real this time, pile two, I am gonna leave things here. I wanna give a big, big, big happy birthday to all of my Scorpios and my November Sagittarians. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I hope everybody has a wonderful November. Thank you guys so much for watching this video and for watching my ads. That is the simplest and easiest way to support me, but if you would like to support me in other ways, you can check out a reading with an extended. You can check out my merch. You can check out my social media. You can comment down below. Let me know how this resonates. You can like this video. You can subscribe to my channel and click that little bell notification to be notified whenever I upload a new reading. But I think that's all I have to say. So I hope you all have a wonderful day or night whenever it is that you're watching this video. And I hope you'll come back and see me again soon. Bye. Hi there, pile three. If you guys chose the Rhodonite palm stone and the Akita, this is going to be your reading on November 2020. So interestingly, I've had my windows open this whole time because I'm actually filming during the day for once. And the sun finally came out for your pile. So I definitely took that as a sign because I started like getting ready and then the sun came out. And so I definitely think that clarity is coming this month for sure. And I definitely understand why, because I kind of took this Akita card. If you're unaware, you can use playing cards as kind of a makeshift tarot deck, but obviously they're not going to have a lot of the major cards because there's only 52 cards in a deck like this. But anyway, the Eight of Hearts corresponds to the Eight of Cups in a tarot deck. And so I definitely think that if you pick this pile and it's meant for you, you're finally walking away. And I don't even want to say walking. It's like you're finally leaving things in the past that no longer serve you. A really obvious example would be like you could be walking away from a friendship, a partnership, something like that. But that's not the vibe that I'm, like, for some of you that could definitely be true. But the overall vibe that I'm getting is you're ready to just bury the past where it belongs. Like, you're done focusing on past things that once brought you fulfillment that don't anymore. You're done focusing on the things that went wrong. I feel like you're just kind of done with the old ways of being. And you're recognizing now that, like, this is not where you want to be in life. This is not how you want to live your life. This is not who you want to be. Or if it's not who you want to be, these past things are not aligned with the person that you're becoming, and you're recognizing that, and so you're distancing yourself from it. But let's go ahead and get your cards out and see what wants to come out. So I have been using the Crystal Power Tarot for each pile. So we'll pull a couple tarot cards, and then we'll pull, I already have your oracles laid out, so we'll look at those too. But Rhodonite, if you felt drawn to this stone and you don't have any of it, Rhodonite is a really excellent heart healing stone. And so I definitely think the biggest thing that you're walking away from is allowing painful memories to continue to live in your head rent free. And I think you're healing a lot of things in your heart that you're like, you're walking away from feeling like you're fucked up, or that you're never going to be loved, or that you're never going to be where you want to be, or you're never going to find the right person. Like, you're walking away from all of these distortions that have kept you small and kept you disappointed. And I think one thing too is I think you're realizing as well, like, you know, especially if there were painful things in your past that you were healing from, I think you were realizing that, like, dwelling in them is not healing it, and that, like, you're at, like, you need to walk away from what you've been trying to do to heal because it's not healing you, if that makes sense. It's like, it's almost like you're like, okay, I've done as much as I can with this with these tools or with this strategy, but, like, I don't see myself really growing beyond that. So that was shitty. Okay, let's go ahead and start. So, Spirit, what can Pile 3 expect for the month of November 2021? What are they experiencing? Okay, so we have the Knight of Cups in reverse. And this is Angel Aura Quartz. I actually have a little piece of it right here, so I'll put it in the reading. But this is Angel Aura Quartz. Mine looks kind of phallic, but still does the trick. So we have the Knight of Cups in reverse, and it says, I know the right person waits until I am ready. What else? Okay, which way does this want to go? Reverse. We have the Seven of Swords in reverse. I'm really happy that wanted to go in reverse. What else? We have the Two of Wands in reverse. we have the Ace of Swords in reverse. And on the back of the deck, we have the Four of Cups in reverse. And I shuffled these really well, so I don't want to hear, you didn't shuffle them enough. If you have a problem, you can come here and shuffle my cards for me. I promise you, after you do that, you will apologize. You'll be like, I'm sorry, Aso, for doubting you. Okay, let's go ahead and look at your oracle cards now. So to start, we have Venus, love. We have Rainbow Bridge. We have Ghost. And sitting on top of the world, we also have the Mountain Goat. It's your animal coming through. We also have Fire. We have Lagus, I don't know, I'm probably not saying that right, but it represents intuition and evolution, and it represents the moon, so Cancer energy could be significant here, as well as Taurus and Libra, because they're both ruled by Venus. We also have Held, and finally we have Visualization, and that's actually where I want to start with this Visualization card, because this Mountain Goat card also talks about visualization. So a big part of your month this month is actually taking the steps to create, to integrate what you visualize into your reality. Because intuitively, you have a really strong intuition, you have really strong psychic abilities. I would say a lot of you are clairvoyant at the very least, or whatever clair you may have, I think that you're very capable of trusting yourself and trusting your own intuition, because you've gotten this far. And one thing that I'm seeing here is that you've already reached a lot of success in your life. In fact, it's really interesting to have all these cards come out in reverse. Because I really, truly think that these are all the things that you're walking away from, that you are leaving in the past. And we'll get there, but I want to start with your oracle. So with the Mountain Goat being here, this is all about visualizing our goals and being focused on reaching them slowly but surely. And usually it's kind of incrementally. But this is definitely a month where you're moving forward, you're moving ahead in life. But one thing I feel like you need to know is that you're really, really hard on yourself. And I think that you place really unrealistic expectations on the type of person that you need to be, especially because you're already such an impressive person. Like, you're already either really accomplished, or wherever you are at in life, like, you are either like on the top tier of what you're doing, the top tier of like a skill or talent or ability, or it may just be that you're on top of the world because you're for once in a financially secure place, or you feel like this is the first time you've been on top. There's a lot about you ascending. And so I think that you have been in this process of evolving and growing. What's this? This card wants to come out. The Emperor. Ha! That's okay. I was like, there's something here that I'm not seeing. And I see it. Oh, fuck. I just touched a candle. That kind of hurt, but that's okay. I'm going to put this down here and we're just going to keep going because this Emperor was meant to come out. Because the interesting thing is we also have the Empress here, not in the tarot cards, but this Venus card represents, is the equivalent to the Empress card in tarot, and they are literally diagonal from one another. And I definitely think that what is changing here is, first of all, you're balancing your feminine and masculine energy in very positive ways. Because I think you've been working on your energy a lot. And one thing that I'm seeing here is that you're developing healthy coping mechanisms for whatever you experience. And I think you're realizing now, or recognizing now that you have the power to make your own choices. And if you don't, that's probably not going to resonate for you. And one thing I will say, because I know there are young people that watch my readings, and one thing I want the young people watching my readings to know is that, you know, if you are under somebody else's control, and I guess this is just for, I'd hope that if you're an adult, you're not under somebody else's control. But if you're a child, like you have to be under somebody's control. Like you don't have any ability to really change that unless you get emancipated. And not everybody's trying to get emancipated. So anyway, I want those young people to know, like, if you are young, if you are not able to make your own decisions yet, to know that someday you will. And you may not feel like you will, you may feel like that day won't come, but there will be a time and a place where you are in charge of your life. Unless you continue to allow people to come in that take control of your life for you, which in that case, you're not living. And I think a lot of you have already ascended and evolved beyond that. But I do want to say for those people who are under somebody else's control, make empowered choices with what you can control now. Accept the things that you can't control, but recognize that at one day, you are going to be in charge of your own choices. And so the sooner you start making those empowered choices and control what you can, the better off you'll be when you're no longer under someone's control. Anyway, that was a side note. But what I'm really seeing here is you're walking away from harmful energies. And instead of making your choices based on fear, based on doubt, based on scarcity, based on the need to hustle or grind, you're making decisions. You're going to start making decisions this month based on love. So my challenge for every single person in this who chose this pile is to ask yourself, what would love do? When you're not sure when to do something, what would the loving response be? How could I do this in a loving way? Because I think what you're walking away from is a lot of distorted masculine energy, if I'm being honest. And it doesn't matter what your gender identity is. This is all about energy. Because we do have some distorted feminine energy here with the emotions. So there was some distortions with your emotional body. But I want to talk about these first, because these are all masculine energies, air and fire. Because I think that the biggest thing that you're walking away from in this month is operating out of fear. Because it's like you've been trying to find this perpetual truth, or this thing that's gonna make a, like, bring out a light bulb in your head, or make you realize like what you haven't been doing correctly, or because you feel like something's missing. And I think what's missing is love. And I don't mean romantic love. I mean love in general. What's missing for you is love, because you have so much already. Like, there's so much to be grateful for, but you're evolving now, and you don't need to use the same coping mechanisms, and you don't need to use the same behaviors to protect yourself or to regulate yourself that you once did. You're changing as a human being, and as a result, you don't need to be so afraid. Because the Two of Wands, now this is like a really specific interpretation, but I think it's very apt here. The Two of Wands is an incredibly masculine card, and the progression from the Two of Wands to the Four of Wands kind of shows the cycle or the process of conquering something. And I think what you have been doing is you've been looking at life as like incremental goals to make happen or things to achieve. And you've kind of looked at your manifestations as things to capture or conquer. And you may not have realized that, but I think there's a lot, like, all of your actions have been guided by this underlying fear that if you don't do it, then it won't happen and you won't be deserving of it. Because one thing that I'm seeing here is I am ready for a breakthrough to success. And I think what you're walking away from is everything that you've been doing in the past, because it's not leading to your breakthrough for success. You already are successful. That's the thing. And I think what people forget and what people don't realize is that success is subjective. You know, if your idea of success is getting $1 million and having a hot spouse and doing XYZ, like, then you're not going to be successful until you do that. But if your idea of success is just being able to get out of bed and function a little bit as a human being, then you're already successful. And I think what you need to realize is that you've been really unfair to yourself with how much you've accomplished, because from what I'm hearing, you are like far above, I don't mean like in terms of value or worth, but far above a lot of people in terms of your spiritual growth, your spiritual evolution, your path, where you want to be, who you are. And for a lot of you, there's a lot of material success here as well. With this Emperor card here, this is legit shit. Like, you are doing well. And honestly, it's surprising that I felt the need to say this message to the younger people watching, because I feel like a lot of people that chose this pile are further advanced in their career, in their life, or in some way. But, you know, I think a lot of this is energy that we're reading. And so, you know, even if you are young, even if you are not able to be in complete control of your life yet, you are mentally strong enough and emotionally mature enough to make empowered choices. And I think what you are realizing is a lot of your actions directly showed you that you didn't value yourself. And like, I think maybe one thing you were looking for a long time was love. But I think what you didn't realize is that you could have never been open to love, because you weren't valuing it. You weren't really open to it. You weren't really, and like I said, this isn't just romantic love. This is love from all types of sources, from friends, from family, from ourselves. And I think for a long time, even though there were a lot of things you had healed, there were things from your past kind of slowly jabbing you and slowly like making you feel like you're not enough, and despite how far you've come. And I think what you're realizing is that you can walk away from that now. Like, it's dead and gone. Like, that time is dead and gone. Speaking of, I know I spirit said that, because this song has literally, I wish you guys could like experience my brain when I'm doing this, because the entire time I've been channeling, this song has been on in my brain in a loop the whole time, because spirit would not let me forget it. So it's literally like I'm trying to listen to what spirit's trying to tell me while I'm listening to this song. But T.I. on top of the world, like literally the lyrics say, because I'm sitting on top of the world, and it's like, first of all, it's a good song. But another song by T.I. is Dead and Gone. And so I think that's why Spirit was like, okay, you don't have to listen to this anymore if you say this song. But the song Spirit wanted you to know about was Sitting on Top of the World. I believe it's by T.I. It's like, and now I see, now I'm sitting on top of the world. And this rainbow bridge is all about crossing into the unknown. And I think what you are now realizing is that you have to step out of your comfort zone in order to embrace these changes. But here's what's really amazing. I do think that love is coming into your life. And the thing is you could already be in a happy, loving relationship. And like, it doesn't mean that it's a new person or something like that. But love in general is coming back into your life. The ability to be open to it, the ability to receive it. Because I think you are very good at giving it, but you're horrible at receiving it. And so as a result, it kind of creates this pattern where you're not open to any love that can come in, because there's no space in your heart, and your heart needs love. But you've probably had ideas and beliefs in the past that in order to receive love, you have to give love. Like, but loving isn't, that's conditional love. Love isn't about giving or receiving. Unconditional love is about the omnipresence of love, especially the omnipresence of love for yourself and the recognition of what would love do? Like, what would a person who truly loves themselves do? And I think that you've been visualizing a lot of these beautiful things for yourself, but you're not like giving yourself the love that you need to get there and to give yourself the time and space to make empowered choices rather than hasty impulsive ones out of fear that everything will disappear. Because with this mountain goat here, like, I feel like with your success, whatever that success is, you're worried that you'll lose it. But Spirit's saying you're climbing a mountain. Like, you're not going anywhere. This is still an uphill battle. You're not done. Like, you may think you're done, but you're not. You're just evolving. And with this fire and held, I think either somebody is coming in, somebody is coming back in, or somebody that is already a part of your life is going to either light or relight your fire and make you feel held. And this could be somebody that you're manifesting through visualizations, whether you know them or not yet. But I think what you realize is that none of this success is truly worth it if you don't have somebody to share it with, if you don't have people to share it with, if you don't have people to be in loving energy with. And so with this Emperor here, I think you're recognizing that you are both, that you're a divine being and that you can be the chaos of creation and love and go with the flow and follow the cycles of life, but you can also trust yourself to look out for yourself and make empowered decisions and make the best decisions for yourself. Because with this Four of Cups in reverse, I think you're tired of the same old story. And it's you being tired of the same old story that is getting you to the point where you're finally ready to let go of a lot of the things holding you back. And what's interesting is that a lot of these things may have made you feel held, but really it just held back your evolution. And so now you're evolving and you're recognizing, okay, I'm ready to make these changes. I'm ready to grow. And so with this Knight of Cups in reverse, I think you've been so afraid of, like, for example, if there's someone special that maybe you're not with right now, that you are hoping that the tide will turn or that things will get better, you may have been perpetuating this energy of, like, blocking that because you may have been focused on the past or have been too afraid. And I think what Spirit, this month is all about you being mindful and allowing yourself to make the changes that you want to create the outcome that you want. But the biggest thing, honestly, there's not a whole lot to change here, but more so you just need to be mindful of how your decisions affect you. So making empowered choices is that mindfulness of what is going to be best for you. Not what is going to make you happiest, what is going to be best for you. Because a lot of times the thing that's best for us isn't always what will make us happiest. Like, I would much rather have mac and cheese for dinner than anything healthy. But I also know that mac and cheese isn't what's best for me, and I need to fuel my body, so I'll probably eat a healthy thing. But the fact that I couldn't think of one probably goes to show that maybe I need to make more empowered choices about the types of foods that I eat. Thanks for putting me on blast, Spirit. Love that. God, this is the hard thing. Like I'm only half here, so Spirit's even like roasting me while we're on it. But I think what you need to recognize is that the best thing you can do is walk away from the belief that you don't know what's best for you, or the belief that good things won't come to you. Because if you follow your inner knowing, you'll get there. And I think you're just afraid to cross into the unknown. And I think you're really afraid of what a life of authenticity and love feels like. And I think Spirit is saying it's time for you to find out. You've done a lot of healing. You've been visualizing this life for a long time. You've come so far. You're doing amazing. But you've got to walk away from the things that are holding you back from embracing love in your present. And like I said, that doesn't mean romantic love. That there's so many different types of love. And I think that you're not able to appreciate any kinds of love right now because your heart is blocked. Your heart is afraid. Your heart is fearful of the unknown. And I think, like, for example, if you're talking to somebody right now, I think you can trust yourself to follow your intuition with this situation and make empowered choices. And I think that Spirit is saying you're more than capable of making the decisions that you need to for your highest good. And Spirit wants you to start visualizing you being successful, visualizing you experiencing love and having the life that you want, rather than using that, because let's be real, instead of visualizing success and what you want, instead you're just using your brain power to fear about all the bad things that could happen. And so it's like, if you're going to use your brain power, you might as well use your brain power to visualize what you want and what you want to happen, rather than visualize or fear or ruminate about the things that could go wrong. Because Spirit wants to keep you warm. Spirit wants you to feel safe, to trust your intuition. And Spirit is saying, you've evolved. You've outgrown a lot of your old behaviors and patterns. You don't need them anymore. They don't serve you anymore. And that's why they don't feel good. And that's why you don't enjoy them. So be open to the unknown. Be open to something new. Be open to what speaks to your heart. And be open to being vulnerable. You know, especially for those of you who may, for example, have the opportunity to meet someone new or have a fresh start with someone from your past. And I'm not saying that this will even happen this month. I mean, it could happen later, but Spirit wants you to be in an energy of love before that happens. You know what I mean? Like, the timing could be entirely dependent on how quickly or slowly you get into this energy. But you need to learn to maintain this energy of love, because I think you experience feelings of love when you are around people that you love or around animals or doing something that you love. But I don't think you've been able to cultivate, like, I don't think you've been able to maintain the experience of allowing love to permeate every aspect of your being and allowing love to make your choices rather than fear. Because making choices based on fear is not empowering, but making choices based on love is. And so, like, for example, you know how when you're up on a high balcony or something, and you just really want to jump off just because, you just have those intrusive thoughts? Well, your fear would tell you, well, I'm not going to jump off of there because I'm afraid of heights, or I'm afraid to die, or I'm afraid of whatever, I'm afraid of hurting myself, whatever that would be. But love would say, I'm not going to jump off of this because I love my life and I don't love being injured. I don't love the possibility of losing my life, and I don't love the idea of any of that. I love everything that is. There's so many things that I love, and there's so many things that I could lose if I jumped off this balcony, for example. I don't know why I'm using balconies as an example, but please don't jump off any balconies. And if you're thinking about something like that, please, please, please get help, because your life is very important. But I don't think any of you are feeling that way. I think you're just not realizing how your fear is holding you back from being empowered, because I think you want to be empowered. I think you want to be in control of your life. But your fear is in control of your life. You're not in control of your life. And the only way to overcome your fear is to allow love to be stronger. And that's, like, something that is relayed in pretty much every piece of media in existence, pretty much, you know? you, and like, you've already done so many things that you had to overcome your fear in order to accomplish. It's nothing, you've already done it before. It's nothing you can't do. But you do need to recognize that, like, your journey is not done. You're not over. There's no destination you're headed to. This is just life. And life is not always exciting, and life is not always amazing. But at the very least, when we're empowered to make our own decisions and we feel free to be the person that we want and we're open to love, that's living. And it's much better than just existing, because I think that's what you have been doing. And I think you're tired of that. And I think you're ready to lead with life. You know, the Knight of Cups follows his heart, or her heart, or their heart. And they're not thinking logically. They're not thinking about what could happen. They're just following their heart. And sometimes that can get you in trouble, but other times it can lead to very beautiful things. But no matter what, anytime your heart leads you somewhere, you're always gonna learn something from it. And like, your heart is never going to lead you astray, because your brain and your ego might think your heart is, because something may not end up the way you thought it would. But when you allow your heart to lead, you still learn something, you still grow. And when your brain and your logical reasoning is in control, when it's fearful, it's gonna make anything seem scary, or seem like it's going to be bad for you. And that's just not fair to yourself. And so I think you need to be open to the idea of just like newness, and that so many parts of your life are over. That hurt you, that made you feel like shit, that made you feel like you weren't in control. A lot of you are in control now. And a lot of you will be in control one day, and already do have a lot of control over things in your life. And so it's time to start, no matter where you are at and no matter how much control you have over your life, it's time to focus your attention on the things you can control, release the things you can't, and be open to what is. Because I think the month of November, once again, is just all about, like, the main idea of these readings, despite like every single pile has had completely different energy, but Spirit has had the same message for every pile so far, and it has been how you see things is what you will make of it. And like, you, the month of November will be what you make of it. So if you continue to do the behaviors that you know no longer serve you, that you know don't fulfill you, and you remain closed off to loving experiences and changing that, November is probably going to be pretty fucking boring, and you're probably not going to be very excited. But I think for a lot of you, you're ready for something new. You're ready to be open to love, and whatever that may be. Even if you're with somebody, maybe you're ready to make empowered choices to prioritize that love and relight that fire and make it a priority, for example. Whatever the case may be, I think you need to understand that, like, you are both daddy and baby. Like, you need to nurture and care for yourself, but you also need to recognize that you're not an infant. You can process language, and you can move around, you can run, you can pay rent, hopefully. You can work, you can play, you can communicate, you can do a lot of shit that babies can't. And while you're still a baby on the inside, you're a big person on the outside. And really, adults are just children in big bodies. But I think what you need to realize is that no one is going to come up to you and say, hey, pile three, congrats, here's your adult badge. You are finally an adult and you can make your own choices. And the fucked up thing, and I was thinking about this actually, is that for a lot of us, depending on your upbringing, I know mine, especially, and by upbringing, I would say where or how you get schooled. I went to a public school that was shitty and horrible and felt like prison. And I'm sure a lot of you can relate to that, because it's being run by bitter adults who don't know themselves. And then project their own insecurities and problems onto children that didn't have them before. Honestly, I wish I could go back in time. Like, I wish I could go to, like, some of my old teachers and just be like, get therapy! Like, you're such an asshole! Like, to children! Like, anyway. But love wouldn't do that. Love wouldn't do that, so we don't do that. Anyway. And it's not our job, but anyway, my point of all of this is, you know, when you're forced to be under somebody's rule and you're forced to follow rules and you're not able to make your own decisions, it's really scary to be able to be in the driver's seat of your own life and take responsibility for yourself. But I promise you, while it is harder, it'll feel way better than placing blame on anyone else, than allowing others to make decisions for you. This is your opportunity to be truly free. And in the month of November, you're getting there. Because you've already made a lot of strides. Like, I feel like for a lot of you, you're at the very least in a place materially or financially to start making changes that you want to start investing or saving, to start setting things up for your future. You don't need to fly by the seat of your pants anymore. There's no need to panic. And I think that's what you're gonna realize. Like, you just need to be more focused on, you know, the next step ahead rather than what's at the top of the staircase or the top of the mountain. And so I think in the month of November, you're going to be learning how to do that and how to get there. And I think there's a lot of loving energy coming in, but it's all about your ability to see it. And so Spirit's saying, keep doing what you're doing and keep being open to the new, because that's what's getting you to this new beginning. And for those of you where you've been really ready for love, or you've been ready for someone or something, it's coming. But you have to believe that it is. And you have to allow yourself to take actions and make the changes necessary to create space for it and welcome it in. So let's go ahead and see what affirmations are going to be relevant for you this month. Because this, interestingly enough, with the Empowered Choices, I am using this personal power deck, so we'll see what you need to say about yourself. So, I am authentic, number 37. So this is Leo energy, which interestingly, we did have the sun come out. We also have Aries energy with the Emperor. And let's see, the Knight of Cups could be water energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, but yeah, with this, I am authentic. I think Spirit is, there's no need for you to be like anyone but yourself. And I think you've already lost a lot of people in your life because you've been your authentic self. And while it may have been hard, I feel like if you're thinking about the people you've lost, ask yourself what you've gained in their absence. Because I did this for myself and I was like, holy shit, like, I've lost some people in my life, but I gained peace. I gained the ability to have time for myself. I gained the ability to make my own decisions. I gained the ability to not live in fear anymore. Like, there's a lot of that. Like, it's easy to focus on the positive qualities of people, but sometimes we need to be objective and recognize where, no matter how much we love somebody, we have to love ourselves more and place boundaries. And if they're not okay with them, allow them to walk away if they're not going to respect them. What other affirmations? I am forgiving. So especially if there is, but like I said that, right? You know, if somebody comes in and wants to change or you want to heal or resolve issues with somebody, I think there's the opportunity for that to happen. So maybe you will have to be the one to make a choice to reach out to somebody from your past to resolve things, only if you feel called to. But I think the biggest thing you need to do is to forgive yourself for what you didn't know in the past, and forgive yourself for existing. Like, that sounds ridiculous, but like, you need to stop feeling bad about existing. Like, your existence actually benefits a lot of people, and it's your own dumb brain's perception that you should feel guilty about your existence. You're wonderful. We also have, I am responsible for my life. And I think that is the big change coming. And we have that number 5. Like, you are learning that you need to be responsible for yourself, and that you can be responsible for yourself. You are daddy and baby, and you need to make daddy decisions to take care of your baby self. You know what I mean? We also have I am a dreamer with this Pisces energy. And so Spirit's saying, don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up on your visualizations. You have the power to get there. But the problem is that you can't get there if you don't change the things that are stopping you from getting there. You see what I'm saying? I feel like this, okay, side note. I feel like this I am authentic card looks so much like Alyssa Edwards. Girl, look how fucking orange you look. Okay, I'm just thinking about RuPaul's Drag Race now, but that was just a side note. But we're actually going to finish off. Actually, no, I want you to see what's on the back of the deck first. On the back of the deck, we have number 11, and we have I am sacred. And I think you need to see yourself as a sacred soul and not just as a person, and that you're something so much grander and greater than the earthly limitations that were imposed to at this time. But we are actually going to finish off. Oh my God, and we also have number 44 here with Pisces, and we have 8. So 2 8s, and 37 is a 10, which reduces to a 1. In numerology, not regular math, because we don't care about regular math on this channel, but numerology is cool. Okay, let's go ahead and finish off with a piece of advice from Spirit. So, Spirit, what advice do you have for pile 3 when it comes to the month of November, please? So, we have, imagine yourself manually turning off your autopilot mode. Look around. This day has never existed before. And there's a quote that says, days are unusual. And I think that this is pretty much exactly what I was telling you. You're ready to turn autopilot off and be the pilot yourself. And I think what you'll find is when you're actually operating things and when you're actually in control of things, you'll be shocked at how quickly life evolves and how much more content you'll feel because you're actually giving yourself room to make the choices and decisions that your higher self wants you to, rather than your 3D physical body that may just be making impulsive choices in the moment to relieve a stimuli or experience. Let's see what's on the back of the deck as well. This is so true. The world does not begin and end with what you have known of it. There is so much deliciousness you've yet to discover. And I think that this is the best way to describe this love energy that's coming in. It's like, it's deliciousness, like wonderfulness. Like, and you know, like Taurus and Libra, for example, are both ruled by Venus, but Libra is a lot more about partnership energy and things like that, whereas Taurus is a lot about, you know, tangible objects, like the finer things in life, right? And so I think that one thing that the Spirit is saying as well is, you know, especially if you have more access to abundance and things like that, if you have the abundance to make things happen that you've always dreamed of, it's time to make empowered choices to get there because you have everything in your power to get there. And so with this, it says, what luck or fate, instinct or grace brought me here in shade beneath the stars. And I think what you're realizing is that your world is ending in the sense of this world of fear, this world of not being good enough, this world of I don't think I can achieve what I want is ending. And you're discovering a whole new world, Jasmine and Aladdin. You need to find your magic carpet. You're discovering a whole new world that's full of wonderful things. And it's only, and you will only be able to do that by, well, no, let me say this. You've only been able to do this by growing and evolving and learning. And you've come so far and you need to be so proud of yourself. Spirit is so proud of you because they're saying, listen, you are ready. You are yourself and you are ready to go. So whether there's people coming into your life, honor what you love and who you love. And if who you love is not in alignment with your highest good, you may need to make some assessments. You may need to talk with them. You may need to work out the kinks, make your own decisions. But this is especially for those who, if there's somebody that you love that is not in your life right now that you want to be, don't hide that. Don't hide that love. Because if you're secure in yourself, even if they reject your love or they don't want your love, you'll know that you're fine. You've got you. You've got your back. And that there will be somebody who does appreciate it. And treating people in loving ways often shows their true nature and their true intentions. So, you know, if you act loving and kind towards somebody and they don't reciprocate or they're not able to receive it, then that is a good indication that that person is just not at the place where you're at. And you'll be able to know because you recognize from personal experience that you haven't been able to receive love either. And so it will also help you empathize and recognize where maybe people just aren't ready yet to receive you, and that's okay. Doesn't mean that you need to wait for them or do anything, but it helps you take things less personally and see them as a fault on you when really it's just where that person is at with what they have. But overall, it definitely seems like things are getting better. But your challenge is to be grounded and mindful this month and be open to receiving. And be open to taking actions that put you in the place to receive. So, yeah. I hope that was helpful, Pile 3. This one was a little interesting, but I really hope that this resonated. So I think I'm gonna leave this reading here. I do quickly want to say happy birthday to all of my Scorpios and happy birthday to my November Sagittarians. I hope you all have a wonderful day. Thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you so much for watching my ads. That is the simplest and easiest way to support me. But if you would like to support me in other ways, you can check out my merch, you can check out my social media, you can like this video, you can comment down below, let me know how it resonates, you can subscribe to my channel, you can click that little bell notification to be notified whenever I upload a new reading, you can tell your friends, you can share readings, or you can do nothing. It's really up to you. But if this helped you, I appreciate anything in return. But yeah, I hope this made sense. I hope you all have a wonderful November. I hope that this resonated. Thank you so much for letting me read your cards. I want to tell you to get excited for this month. Like, actually get excited, because the more you cross into the unknown, the sweeter life is going to get. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this reading. I hope it resonated. I hope you all have a wonderful day or night whenever it is that you're watching this, and I hope you'll come back and see me again soon. Bye! Hi there, Pile 4. If you guys chose the Smoky Quartz Palm Stone and this bearded collie, this is going to be your reading. I love this guy. He's so cute. I just love his little smile. Anyway, I have been looking at the actual playing card to see what potentially your current energy is right now. And the Nine of Clubs translates to the Nine of Wands in tarot. And so I definitely think that you're at a place in time where you're doing the best you can, but it's like that exacerbated, like, I'm exhausted, I'm holding out, but I don't know what I'm holding out for. Well, some of you may be holding out for something, but for others, you may just be, you know, exhausted and trying to run through the motions or something like that. But with the Nine of Wands, it means the Ten of Wands is coming, which Ten of Wands means overwhelm, which then leads to the Ace of Wands, a new beginning. So you're getting closer to the end of a cycle, but we have to see what's going on. So I have used the Crystal Power Tarot deck today, if you're curious which deck I was using. But we'll pull four cards and then see what's on the back of the deck. And then we'll look at your oracles and then we'll get going. So if you felt drawn to any other piles, I will say that, like, all the energies themselves have been different, but a lot of the core messages that spirit wants to get across have remained the same. So I think as a collective, while we're all going through different things, we're all kind of reaching the same conclusions. And I think that's kind of one of the beautiful things about how spirit works is, like, you know, there's no one solution fixes all for anything. And I think the more that we recognize that, like, different experiences and different solutions will help, both help and hurt us, in terms of our healing, like, the more we know ourselves, the more we can be, like, we can be responsible for meeting our needs. But also, you know, I just do think, like, it's very easy to feel isolated and jaded because of your own problems and what you're going through. But, like, even though people may be going through different problems, like, the beauty of tarot is that it gets rid of all the semantics and it shows the underlying energy. And so you might be like, how can all these people relate to me? And it's like, well, first of all, it's not that very many people. You're all dispersed around the entire world. But also, like 100 to 200,000 out of 8 billion people is really not a lot, but it seems like a lot. But what's cool is that you're, just through this reading, you're connecting with people that have similar energy to you, and you'll probably never meet most of them, but they're out there and they're going through life just the same way you are. They're dealing with problems just like you are. Humans are not that different from one another, you know? We think we are because we see all the differences and we look for differences, but we don't look at how we're the same very often, which I just think is lame. But that's why I like tarot, because it eliminates that. Anyway, I don't know what that was about. This is about your reading. So spirit, what can pile four expect? Okay, so we have the Queen of Swords upright. What can pile four expect for the month of November 2021, please? Okay, just want to be upright or reversed? I don't trust that. Spirit, which way? Okay, I feel like it wants to be upright, so I'm gonna go with upright. Okay, yeah. We have the Five of Wands upright. What else, Spirit? And we have two more. So we have the Lovers in reverse. And we have the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. And on the back of the deck, wow, okay, we have the Ace of Cups in reverse. And it says, I welcome new love and trust what it brings. It's underneath that, the Eight of Wands. Meow, meow. Okay. All right, let's look at your oracles now. So, to start, we have the Grand Cross, Provoker. We have the Hold. We have the Sun, which I do want to mention. The Sun is coming out for your reading. We have Predictions of Growth. We have the Spider in reverse. We have Gratitude. We have Accomplishment and Life Cycles. This is a rune card and it says Jera, J-E-R-A. I'm probably saying that wrong, if I'm being honest. But I'm gonna move this Ace of Cups down here. And finally, we have the World and Soul Healing. So this is one step above the crown chakra. I think it's called, like, the Star Soul Chakra, but I think that's a mouthful, so I just call it the Mega Crown Chakra. Or I would just call it the Star Chakra, like, it's spacey and shit. Anyway. There's gonna be some people that are gonna be like, I don't wanna hear this message. But, this is the message that's coming out. Don't don't hate the reader. Like, don't pick. Okay. I'm going to get on my soapbox for 2 seconds and then I'm going to get into your reading. Okay. I have no control over what comes out or what messages come through. Because if I tried to control it, then I would feel horrible. Because first of all, I wouldn't know anything. You know, when y'all are like, how do you know XYZ? It's like, I don't know any of this. Like, I'm just going off of what my intuition is telling me. And that's why I have to trust. I don't fucking know. But oftentimes we have expectations or wants, right? And so sometimes I see people that are not happy with the messages that they get. Like, for example, I didn't want to hear about love. I wanted to hear about my career. It's like, that's great, but that's not the message that came through. You know, that's how spirit works. And I'm not saying that because, like, I'm upset at people that are like that. I'm just saying, or at you if you've done that. I'm just saying, like, when it comes to spiritual work and getting messages from spirit, spirit doesn't give a shit about what you want to hear. Spirit's going to tell you what you need to hear. And it doesn't matter what you want. Spirit's not a business. Spirit's not telling you what you want. Spirit is telling you what you need to hear and what you're supposed to hear and what they're trying to tell you. Now, obviously, there is a level of obviously, because there needs to be somebody communicating, physically communicating, there can be issues in interpretation or understanding. But honestly, like, I pretty much trust myself at this point. I trust the messages that I receive and that they're what people need to hear. But you need to also trust yourself that if it's not what you want to hear, then either don't listen to the message or suck it up and listen to the message if you know you should. If it's not what you want to hear and you know it's not relevant to you, then don't sit through the whole reading. There's no point, okay? Like, you have control. You clicked on this video, you picked a pile, you have control to exit as well. You're in control here. That's just all I'm saying. Embrace that control. Embrace being able to make the decisions that you want. But I gotta be honest, pile four. I'm seeing some love energies here. But for some of you, it has nothing to do with love and everything to do with just yourself. But for some of you, there's definitely somebody involved here. I mean, with the Lover's card here, and the Grand Cross and the whole predictions of growth in the world and the Ace of Cups, there's a lot of signs pointing to all of this. So let's just go ahead and get into it. I'm not sorry. I said what I needed to say. And now we'll start. So let's start with this card. It talks about accomplishment and life cycles. And the interesting thing is I was hearing in my head, like, don't you forget about me. And I was like, that's interesting. And then I realized, if you've ever seen the movie The Breakfast Club, this looks a lot like, the ironic thing is I've seen The Breakfast Club multiple times. I've never seen Riverdale, but I want to call him Jughead. He's not Jughead. I know he's not Jughead. He's something else. I don't know. The guy that plays the kid at the very end that lifts his fist up and he's that rebellious, like, you know, whatever his name is, I'm blanking right now. I'm sure everybody in the comments will tell me, but this looks like the guy in that movie, even though I can't remember his name, and it's not Jughead, and I know that, and I'm like, Spirit, why are you talking? Maybe Jughead is significant to you guys. I've never seen Riverdale, so, like, I don't know. Anyway, you know, I think The Breakfast Club is an interesting movie for spirit to bring up, because, you know, it is a lot about identity and it is a lot about, like, the cycles of time and change and growing and evolving. And even though it only takes place in one day, there's a lot that happens and a lot that changes. And, you know, the people that enter that high school, they entered one way and left another, you know? And I think what's really exciting for everybody in the month of November is that you have the opportunity to heal something really, really big. And I think for a lot of you, this healing has to do with a divine counterpart situation. And so when I say divine counterpart, I need you to take out of your mind the typical interpretations, or take out of your mind the typical human understandings, distortions, expectations, and belief about how love should look, what love should be. Because if you are in a divine counterpart situation, you will know that connections like that don't really adhere to human expectations. Because humans are full of bullshit bureaucracy, and it works on a human level, but on a soul level, it can distort things because you have to have the ability to look beyond that. Because a regular, like, for example, like, everybody expects that just because, like, if two people love each other, then they're going to be together and be happy, right? Well, that's not always how it works, right? You know, life is messicated. I was about to say complicated and messy, and I said messicated. Life does get messy, and shit does get messy. And so what I'm seeing here is, for some of you, if you don't have a divine counterpart that you know of, then this month you're healing your relationship with yourself in a very powerful way. Actually, no matter what, everybody here is repairing, is healing their relationship with themselves in a powerful way. But the thing is if you already do have a divine counterpart in your life, you may be doing some really significant healing that not only heals yourself, but helps your counterpart as well. And so what's interesting is I think that you're finishing out a cycle this month with your divine counterpart or with yourself. Because if you don't have a divine counterpart, you are your divine counterpart, and that's all that matters. So for some of you, you could be seeing this person in person. And if that's the case, I do think that there could be a lot of healing here. But I also think that there's a need to be focused on yourself first. Because if this is a divine counterpart that, like, you're aware of, that you've been aware of for a while, that you've done a lot of healing with, that you'll know who you are, I think you're ready to finish out this cycle. Whether it's a cycle to gain closure with them or a cycle for a new start, I think you're ready for closure. Because maybe for some of you, you've realized that you need to protect what matters to you. So you may be reaching out to this person. You may be taking efforts to, at the very least, communicate with this person and talk openly. But what this month is showing is only like, it's like if you had what's that called? What do detectives use? A magnifying glass. It's like you need a magnifying glass. It's like we're looking at this the month of November is just a magnifying glass on something that is like literally infinite and constantly changing and shifting. But the thing is that when it comes to your journey, either with loving yourself or healing, I also feel called to say this. If you do not have a divine counterpart that you know of, one, that is completely okay. And two, it is completely understandable that it seems stupid, or that it looks a certain way, or that it just doesn't seem real, or that it seems unhealthy, or things like that. And I understand why a lot of people maybe feel apprehensive about these concepts or feel frustrated because you come to these readings and you can't relate to a lot of the energies. And I just want to say, for those of you who do have a divine counterpart, to not feel shame for it. Like, it's so ridiculous to feel shame for it and to feel bad for it. Because what we as a collective are not recognizing is that we place judgment on other people all the time. Like, all the time. And anyone who has not experienced a divine counterpart connection simply cannot empathize with people who have. And that's not because somebody is not empathetic enough or not, or doesn't know how to love enough or some ridiculous shit like that. It has nothing to do with that. And it more so has everything to do with the experience of it. And just how fucking insane it is. How batshit insane it is. And how it makes the people that experience them feel insane. It makes the people that experience them feel isolated. It makes the people that experience them feel guilty. And they take a lot of healing. And they really will do a number on you. In positive and negative ways. And in positive ways, it's often to heal. But in negative ways, it's often out of fear of something bad happening. What's the point of me saying all this, Spirit? Okay, so for the people that don't have divine counterparts, I ask that if you're part of this community, to be sympathetic towards the people who do, because I promise you, you think you understand it, but you cannot understand it until you've experienced it. And there's nothing saying you won't. So you may very well be in the same situation that a lot of people are in now, in the future. And if you have the opportunity to be on the other side of things, you'll realize where maybe you were unfair or harsh to people that you didn't even know, or judgmental towards people you didn't even know, because you assumed that something didn't exist based upon your experience. And I was one of these people. But as a reader, all of these energies that you experience, like, at some point, like, you see things with your own eyes. I mean, it's something you truly can't understand unless you live it for yourself. And so if you're not living that, I understand your frustrations, but I ask that you be patient when messages like this come through, because there are people who need it, who need this guidance and can't access it anywhere else. And the experience of it, and the experience of all of it, is incredibly isolating. And a lot of times, the people that go through these connections or experience these connections feel very isolated and alone, and end up making their situations worse because they're listening to common advice and horrible, horrible things, not horrible things, but, like, you know, bad advice that is given with good intentions but does not serve anything, does not help anyone, and only makes them more confused. And I guess for some of you, maybe there is somebody coming in that could be a divine counterpart for you that you need to be aware of if you're hearing about this. But for a lot of you, I think this month is going to be huge in terms of healing your divine counterpart connection if there's already history there. And with the lovers coming out, like, there isn't another way for me to interpret this other than you're either healing the relationship with yourself, or healing the relationship with yourself is resulting in you healing your relationship with your divine counterpart in some way. Now, your divine counterpart's behavior in the 3D is not representative of their true 5D energies. The same way what you do in the 3D isn't representative of your true 5D energies all the time. And so this healing, so I guess what I'm saying is I don't want to, like, I don't want you to place some expectations on what may happen because you may not even hear from this person this month. For a lot of you, I feel like you will, if I'm being honest. I definitely feel like something's happening here, but I don't want to. But for some of you, you may need to create that opportunity. It may not happen unless you create it. And if you don't want to create it, then it may not happen. And maybe you don't need to. Maybe it's not time. Maybe there needs to be time. There needs to be time apart, or you need to be doing your own thing. Trust whatever the universe is telling you. But no matter what, healing is happening here. And I think that what you've been holding out on is maybe if you can communicate with your divine counterpart, maybe telling your divine counterpart the truth about your feelings or the truth that they matter to you. Like maybe you've never even told them that they matter to you, because with this Queen of Swords, I protect what matters to me. And the Five of Wands, I stand my ground and look for peace. You haven't been at peace since you met this person, or you haven't known peace now. So what I'm seeing is you're going to have the opportunity this month to heal this connection in some way, and to heal yourself, to heal your souls, because this is a soul-based connection. This is not a 3D-based connection, you know? Soul connections kind of almost work in the opposite way, where they like, where instead of getting to know someone, they just draw. It's almost like the physical has to play catch up with what your soul already knows. And so with this spider card here, Spirit's saying that you may need to create an opportunity for this to happen. Like if you're ready, if you want something more out of this connection, or if you want to tell this person your truth, you can't go wrong if your actions are rooted in love and have no expectations of outcome. I think what you're learning is that you can't place expectations on this person or on this experience, but that instead you have to take what you can learn from it and do your best with what you can. And you know, both you and this person have free will. And if you don't have a person, then it's just you, and you are learning in this month to protect your free will. Because actually what I'm seeing here for all of you, there's a cycle closing when it comes to people pleasing. You're recognizing that you need to stand your ground, look for peace, and protect what matters to you. And I think as a result, you are going to be setting boundaries with certain people. You're going to be walking away from certain things. For some of you, maybe the opposite is happening. Maybe you're in a relationship, and this month you're deciding that there's nothing left that can be salvaged here, and you don't feel safe with this person. You don't feel protected by this person. So I would say either this is a divine counterpart situation, or you're already with somebody who it's either not a great relationship, or you've tried to work through it and it's not working and you're ready to kind of move forward, move on. When it comes to the Grand Cross, this talks about a lot of challenging energies that need to be, it literally talks about the process of meeting challenge and needing to separate, rebuild, and come back stronger so that things can truly align. Because I think for some of you, if this is a past person, things were never going to align in the past, and that things were always meant to happen this way so that you could grow, so that you could see the light, so that you could see the truth, so that you could heal. And it's through this healing that is going to allow you and this person to show up authentically, but you can only be responsible for your part. If your person doesn't want to show up in the same way or can't show up in the same way, that says everything about them and nothing about you. But when you're in a good, healthy place and you're loving yourself, you're able to recognize that rather than see it as a fault with yourself and wonder what's wrong with you. So this month, you're being challenged to complete this cycle, to stand your ground and to protect what matters to you. But what Spirit wants you to be aware of is where maybe you're closed off. So like this Queen of Pentacles says, I have everything I need to prosper. You may be feeling like the time may be coming for you to make some moves or changes. And you may be like, well, wait, this isn't perfect or that isn't perfect. And I think Spirit is saying, that doesn't matter. That never did matter. It's all about your energy. And with this Ace of Cups, I welcome new love and trust what it brings. Because even if, because let's talk about the word love. The word love is abused so much. And in fact, a lot of abusive people like to use the word love, but they have no idea what love even means. And so, especially one thing, like, you know, with stuff like this, is people can confuse divine counterpart energy with like very intense karmic energy. And here's the thing, you can have intense karmic energy with a divine counterpart, but that's pretty much almost always transmuted and transcended eventually over time. Whereas with a karmic energy, with somebody that you just are here to resolve something with, you're not going to feel the same way about them over time. Like, you'll probably feel really strongly at first. Like, eventually you won't feel anything for them anymore. But with divine counterparts, because there's that soul energy, oftentimes the karmic issues are transcended and the only thing left that remains over time is love. So if you don't know if someone's a divine counterpart, give it time. And the more you heal, the more you grow, the more you'll be able to look at the situation from a place of love and detach and see it with a place of love. And so you'll either know, oh, okay, so we both were definitely acting out our triggers, our fears, projecting them onto one another. And I want to grow and heal this. I want to heal beyond this. Like, this person matters to me and I want to protect this connection in any way I can. Obviously, you can't force anyone to do anything. But there's also the side of, you know, if you grow and change and you heal and you recognize that they were never, that you just don't feel the same way or you just don't feel it anymore, then that's a good sign that that was somebody that you were meant to learn a lesson from. They weren't somebody that was meant to be in your life forever. But obviously, even if somebody is your divine counterpart, if their behavior doesn't change, then you shouldn't keep them in your life. Or you shouldn't allow them to stay in your life without respecting you and your boundaries, because that is the most important part here. But I think what you need to understand, so maybe for some of you, you could be meeting your divine counterpart this month or very soon. But no matter where you're at, you're closing out a cycle. And so if you've been on this journey for a while, or if you've been healing and growing and evolving, and you resonate with the idea of this being a divine counterpart situation, then Spirit is saying, we're giving you the opportunity this month to heal. You may need to take action. We may set it up for you. How it's going to be is different for everybody. But you have to be open to receiving. You have to trust that you're ready. And you have to trust your inner knowing about this situation and make a commitment to do what will protect what matters most for you. And you'll be willing to fight and face conflict if it means getting what you want. Or not getting what you want, look for peace. You don't want to be fighting for what you want. If you're coming to this person authentically from a place of love, then it doesn't really matter what happens. When you give this person space to show up as they are rather than what you hope they will be, it gives you a clear gauge of how ready they are and how ready you are and how much you've healed. And so I feel like for a lot of you, you know, if you've dealt with this a difficult situation in the past, and this doesn't even have to be a romantic person, it could be a friend or somebody that you feel really connected to. But if you want to resolve things, there's always that option. Sometimes it's our pride and our ego that gets in the way of resolving things. And so, and for some of you, you may find that this person isn't able to show up for you, and that it might be time to close this cycle and just keep moving forward, you know? Because no matter what, the person you need to be protecting is you, and you need to stand your ground and look for peace. And if you can't find peace within this situation, or there's another person within this situation and they won't give you peace or refuse to help you with that, then they're clearly not aligned with you at this time. But I think for some of you, you are coming into alignment with this person, and there may be an opportunity to change something, to heal from something in the past, and to start things fresh without any expectations. But I think one thing that you need to start doing is be present with your negative emotions. Be present with, sit down with your negative emotions and ask why they're there. Instead of pushing them away, honor them the same way you would anything else. Like, for example, if you're afraid of reaching out to this person, ask yourself why. If you know in your heart, whatever your truth is, why are you so afraid, or what's going on here? Or, you know, if you do end up disappointed, or you are afraid of rejection, or you are afraid of whatever, when you can find a safe place within yourself, it doesn't matter what happens in the external world, because you've always got somebody to fall back on, and that somebody is you. And so I think that if you've been going through this process with the divine counterpart of healing, of growing, of evolving, then I think spirit is saying that we're giving you the opportunity to either see this person face to face, to interact with this person, or to do some kind of healing that will give you the opportunity to experience something new with this person. Or it'll give you the opportunity to see where this person is at with their own healing and help you know whether this is something worth pursuing or not. Because if somebody is not, we're not going to give you your time and energy, then it's not worth it, right? But this month, you're going to be able to see just how far you've come, because you know that you have to honor your boundaries. You know you have to honor your soul. And there's a lot of light here. We have Leo energy here. We have Gemini energy here. We have Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus energy here. I guess we have a lot of energy. We have air energy here as well. More Gemini. Jeez, I can't stop burping. Libra, Aquarius. But I would say that anybody who's in a divine counterpart situation, it may take a lot of time, but over time, you'll probably look back on those experiences and be grateful for them. Actually, that's not true, because you can be that way with anyone. You can look back and be like, yeah, maybe it wasn't the best, or yeah, it was really great, but like, you can look back on something and be like, I'm grateful for what we had, but this doesn't work now, or I'm grateful for things not working out because it got me to the place that I'm at now. It's got me to my healing. And maybe for some of you, this has nothing to do with your counterpart and everything to do with you. And just that by this month in November, you've reached a point in healing where this connection doesn't really matter, in the sense of that you need to protect and maintain it. But instead, you're recognizing that yourself, your own peace, is what is more important, and everything else is secondary, including divine counterparts. But it does seem like no matter what, you're growing and evolving, and your counterpart is growing and evolving as well. But evolution and growth can be very small and incremental, and so small that it can almost be hard to see. So for some of you, I think if more time has passed, you may have the opportunity to really see just how both of you have grown. But for others, you know, there may not be anyone involved here other than yourself. And it's just that maybe you can't commit to a path. You can't commit to what it is you want to do. And so your healing cycle has been all about finding your happiness, allowing yourself to grow, learning how to nurture yourself when you do experience difficult things, or you do experience bad energies. But with the World card here, I mean, you could be traveling, so maybe you're meeting this person traveling somewhere. I mean, when it comes to people, any people involved that you're experiencing these difficult, like, whoever this person is, if there is a person involved, they're fated. Like, there's a destined quality there where, like, and I don't mean fated in the sense that, like, they're fated to be your ooh-woo lover for the rest of your life, but they're fated to come into your life and teach you things. What you both choose to do with your energy is up to free will. And that's how I see every divine counterpart situation, if I'm going to be honest. I do think part of the problem is that humans have a lot of distortions around what love should look like and what love is. Like I said, I think the word love is abused, and I think people say that they love people when they're not like actually in love. Maybe they just love control, or they love the entitlement through what they get by... There's just a lot of people that say that they love people, but it's not really love. Like, they're just saying that word. Like, you know, love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not demand. Love simply allows and gives. And so I think if you are looking at this situation with love for yourself and looking out for your best interests at first, but being open to compromise and growth, I think that's going to be very helpful. But I think there's a need to recognize where, look into your own perceptions of love and what is truly love, and what is something that you thought was love, but is actually control, or this person's way of saying that they like, I feel like I'm going in circles in this pile. And that's the thing is, yeah. If you pick this pile, you probably do feel like you've been going in circles, either with this person, this situation, all of it. And you're ready to heal it. And you have been healing. You have been growing a lot. And Spirit's saying that maybe for some of you, you might be feeling like it's time to attempt to grow together if this person is willing to collaborate with you. But if not, I think it's just healing a lot with this connection so that you can stand your ground and look for peace and continue protecting what matters to you and not be worried about what someone else is doing. Because I think that there's already a lot of light and a lot of happiness in your life. I think just what you need to recognize now is that you've completed a lot of healing that you've needed to do when it comes to your relationship with yourself, or when it comes to your relationship with the divine counterpart. And so there may be the opportunity to, I don't want to say fix, but to change the energy and to come forward and see what's going on. But for others of you, I definitely think that this is more so like, for example, maybe you're finding that a person that you did care about a lot just isn't the right person for you anymore, and that you can't stay in something if you're losing your peace and you can't stand your ground, or you can't... or you feel like you can't protect yourself. And sometimes we have to recognize that, like, you got to be grateful for what is and keep moving forward. But I forgot I was going to say this. I welcome new love and trust what it brings. So new love doesn't have to mean new love from a new person. It very well could be. But it also could be accepting love that is actual authentic love and not something disguised as love. So recognizing what love actually is and being patient with that. Because you may find, even if you are in a divine counterpart situation, that likely when you first started out in this connection, or you first experienced this connection, a lot of your desires around it probably were ego desires. You probably wanted them to give you the responses that you wanted, or give you the attention that you wanted, or give you what you wanted your ego to be about. You felt a lot for them and you really wanted them to validate your ego. And so being rejected or things not working out with them will kill your ego. And as a result, your ego may want to fight for them back to prove that you weren't wrong, or that you weren't lying to yourself, or that this person did feel something for you. Like, you might be trying to prove something to your ego rather than to... Well, that's the thing. If you're trying to prove something, that's an ego thing. If they're truly a divine counterpart, you may not know immediately, but you will know eventually. And when you do know eventually, you will know in your soul. And there's nothing that can happen on this 3D earth that can break that bond or destroy that bond. Now, that doesn't mean that you'll interact on the earth at all. I mean, like I said, that's a free will thing. But when y'all check out of Earth, you're gonna be like you'll be reunited. Like, I think it's important to remember that what happens on the physical plane is a lot less important than the soul truths behind it. Because the truth of the matter is, it doesn't matter how much you accumulate, it doesn't matter how much you achieve, it doesn't matter how far you go, you have the same fate as every other single human being on this planet. And that is the fate of your human meat body rotting, well, not rotting, decaying, ceasing to function, and rotting in the ground, and then becoming part of the world. I don't mean to give you an existential crisis, but I don't think you'll have one if you've gotten this far in this reading. Everything that you both do in this 3D world will end at some point. So literally nothing lasts forever on the physical plane. But a soul truth, like someone that you feel connected to on the soul level, you can never be away from them. You're never truly separated from them. You're never truly away from them. Because souls and energy can move at the speed of light. They're instantaneous. It's a little bit magical, but I think it needs to be normalized, because the only reason it's seen as magical is because it's not normalized. And I think that this kind of situation, I will say, if you don't have a divine counterpart yet and you're still watching this reading, it's quite possible that you could be meeting yours soon. I think that we are going to find more and more people discovering, meeting their divine counterpart, or discovering that they have one. Because I bet that there are a lot of people that do have one that don't even realize that they are one, because of the typical human beliefs around what connection should be and what they should look like and what they mean. And the one thing I love about connections like these is that they force us to look at things differently. And I think that you're looking at things a lot differently than you did when you first started this cycle, or than you did when you first started just being open to love or life or anything like that. So I think what Spirit really wants you to know is that you've gained a lot of clarity, you've learned a lot, and you're ready to continue healing. And recognize that a lot of, like, the difficult things of the past are behind you for the most part. You're always gonna experience difficult things, because that's life. But the point of experiencing difficult things is not to be afraid of them or that difficult things are bad. Difficult things give you the opportunity to overcome challenges, so that when a similar difficult thing comes, you already have tools to address those difficult things. Because the difficulty with divine counterparts is you guys are projecting all of your shit onto each other. You got a lot of wounds, and you're being triggered, you're being purposely felt insecure. Like, and it's neither of your faults, it's just your state of being. And I think you need to recognize that when it comes to divine counterparts, there's no goal or there's no finish line. It's just a connection, but it's a very significant connection, because it's one of the connections that's closest to you, to your soul, to your heart. And so that's why your heart focuses on it. And your heart is focusing on it because your heart also wants to heal that. And so one thing that Spirit wants you to know is that if you ever want to be at peace with this situation, you can't place expectations on it. You have to lovingly allow people to show up. You can create opportunities, but oftentimes you may not want to create an opportunity because you're afraid of rejection or you're afraid of being ignored, right? Well, that fear is telling you something. It's telling you that you're not ready for this like you think you are. Because even if you're afraid, if you're confident in yourself and recognize that no matter what that person's response to you is, it doesn't have bearing on your being or your worth as a human, you'll be just fine. And I think that's a big process of what Spirit is trying to get you to realize, is that you are your own light. You are complete just by yourself. And that while having a connection with another person is really special, your healing comes first. And if there's something that you can do to heal with this person, Spirit is saying that we're kind of opening this up for you to have that happen if you want to. If you don't want to, you don't have to do anything. But this month is huge for your healing, and this is what you need to know. But if you're not in a divine counterpart situation, I would say that all of this healing really has to do with you getting rid of people-pleasing tendencies, healing a lot of things at the soul level, and not putting up with half-assed people, half-assed love offers, half-assed energy from anyone. You're going to protect your integrity, and you're going to start only allowing people in your life that match your energy and that add to your life. And so all of these difficult things that you've been experiencing have been provoking you to heal and go within. And when you're, and now healing never ends, but healing specific things at a point should. Those wounds can be reopened when they're triggered in the future, but healing, it's like you have to tend to those wounds, right? So in this case, I think what you really need to know is that like every single pile, and once again, completely different energy than all three, this month is what you make of it. Take action to protect what matters to you, but stand your ground and protect your peace. If anything takes away your peace, don't do it. Hold firm with what is true to you and be honest and be willing to be vulnerable about what matters to you and who matters to you. Because some people may just be coming, showing up in ego because they think you're an ego as well, and they're afraid of rejection. The more you understand about yourself and the more empathy you have for yourself, the more empathy you have for humanity. And there are certain things that people just can't empathize with. And for example, one of them being a situation like this when you've never experienced it. That's often why people can mistake, I think I said this already, but that's often why people can mistake intense karmic connections for divine counterparts. But it's only until that person experiences a divine counterpart energy, then they'll know the true difference. So even if that's been the case for you, you can't beat yourself up, but you also can't generalize and say that, oh, that's what all of these connections are, because that's not true. That's a distortion. And there's a lot of human distortions around what divine counterparts should be. They think that they should be together forever and have become married and have a million babies. And that's just not how life works. You know, that doesn't mean that you won't be together. It's straight up a matter of free will. You have the same likelihood of ending up with your divine counterpart as anyone else, so long as you both mutually want that. And if you both mutually want it, then there's nothing standing in the way. But if one of you doesn't want something or one of you isn't ready for that, you have to be patient with that. But also, that doesn't mean that you have to slow down and wait for them, because it's your life too, and you're allowed to do what you want. So at the end of the day, one thing that you need to know is that no matter what, divine counterpart or not, one of the biggest purposes of having this is to relearn how to love yourself. And relearn how to like see yourself. It shows you everything about yourself that you were unaware of, that is unhealed, that needs to be healed. And it sucks, and it's a process, but it will get you where you need to go. And you may find that at the end of that process, that maybe your divine counterpart, while you feel a deep connection to them at the soul level, maybe isn't the person that is ideal for you to spend your life with. Or maybe you get through all this healing and you realize, oh, my divine counterpart is the person who I really do want to spend my life with. And I want to protect the option of that outcome. And so I want to communicate that to them, or I want to do this, or I want to do that. Like, if you find that that's what your soul knows, that's what your soul wants, then be open to allowing that to happen. But at the same time, you can't push everything away. You know what I mean? Like, when it comes to, don't place a particular expectation on a person. If you have an expectation that you'll get married in your life, for example, have that expectation that you'll get married. Don't have that expectation of who it'll be with. You know what I mean? Because, you know, maybe you need your divine counterpart to meet the person that you're going to be with. And I'm saying all of this not because I want you to feel like nothing will happen with your divine counterpart or that nothing will get there. This topic is important to talk about because not enough people talk about it, and there's a lot of distortions around the people that talk about it a lot. Well, no, I don't want to shame anyone. Nobody knows the truth. But my truth is that I don't think that there is a set plan for anyone. I think that everybody's journey is different. I think everybody's needs in this lifetime are different. And I think the overall goal of a divine counterpart connection is different for every single one. For some of you, the goal may be to spend your life together, to grow, heal, spend life together. For others, it may be to grow and to heal and to be a better evolved version of yourself for somebody that can align with you in that at that frequency and get you in alignment with somebody that is going to be for your highest good. It's just everybody's purpose is different. And Spirit does not want you to feel like you're boxed in, that you're forced to do anything. But if it's what your soul wants, you should at the very least be open to pursuing it. And you can't pursue it if you just avoid it forever or pretend like it doesn't exist. And so there's a need to like not shame yourself for the things you experience around it or feel guilty. This was all meant to happen, and this is all provoking you to just heal. Because honestly, the card that sticks out to me most is this soul healing and this lover's card, which like I want to turn it upright. God, I can't fucking pick up anything today. I trust my knowing and make a commitment. And so this commitment that you're making more than anything is to yourself and what you know your soul wants at this point in time. You don't have to know the outcome. You don't have to know where it's heading. Just be open to what could be. Be willing to be vulnerable. Be willing to make concessions. Be willing to be open. The same way any, like, no human relationship is perfect. And human relationships are messy and they take work and they take growth. And if you take away the magnifying glass and you zoom out, you're able to see how this was all just leading you to this point anyway. And it's hard to see that. In the past, it was hard to see that because that wasn't your present moment. But you're getting to the present moment where you're able to be healed. And, let me not say healed. Healed enough to make a decision that's in alignment with your highest good. And so Spirit is saying, whatever that is, you're able to do it. God. Okay, I feel like I've been talking for fucking ever. So let's get your cards now, because that's honestly like, I'm so sorry if that wasn't very helpful, but that's the message. And so if you didn't resonate with this, I would check a different one. But we're going to go ahead and move on into advice now, because I think I'm just reiterating things you already know at this point. This is like all about you clearing out this cycle and recognizing how far you've come, how much you've healed, and it's giving you the opportunity to start fresh. So Spirit, what affirmations does pile four need for the month of November? I am lovable. Yes, that's a big one, that you're super lovable, because you don't believe that you're worthy of this, and that's part of the problem. I am supported. And then you also don't believe that Spirit's actually supporting you in this. And what you need to understand is that Spirit is supporting you and your life and your love life way harder than anybody in your 3D reality is. I can fucking promise you that. And it's not because Spirit is trying. We place these expectations. We think that something is going to happen, but Spirit doesn't like. I just think the best policy when it comes to situations like this is being open-minded, allowing yourself to heal enough to look at the situation objectively, to look at the person objectively, to take them off the pedestal, take off the rose-colored glasses, to see them as a human with flaws just like you, and to just recognize like that you're at where you're at with this and be open. There's just a need to be open here, to be open, to take action, and to not be afraid of rejection. More than anything, if this situation or this person, even if they're not a divine counterpart, they don't have to be a divine counterpart. If they matter to you, you can try to protect that. But at the end of the day, you have to protect yourself first. And that doesn't matter what type of connection you have. What else? I am celebrated. Yeah, you need to celebrate how far you've come. Like how much you've grown and how much you've already healed. Like you're doing amazing. Yeah, I deserve respect and I have a higher purpose. And that is a lot of why this divine counterpart is showing you that. You're showing each other your higher purpose. And you're learning a lot about respect. And so it doesn't matter if this person is your divine counterpart or not. If somebody comes in and they're not respecting you, then they don't need, then you can't, then you, if they can't respect you, then they don't deserve to be in your life. But Spirit is saying, you know, you've learned a lot. You've healed a lot. You've got golden loving light around you. Like, she has the sun around her and she says, I am confident and I'm fearless. That Aries energy, you need that. You need to be bold and take action towards what you want, because it's way too easy to get caught up in waiting for the right time, but maybe the right time doesn't exist and maybe we have to create it. Be confident that no matter what happens, no matter what the outcome will be, you'll be okay. I know this is scary, like, and this is why I'm spending so much time on it. Like, I want to make a video about this topic, but I just, it's hard when I'm not channeling to have the right words for it, you know? And I think what you need to understand about all of this is that your journey is your own. You come to the conclusions that are right for you, and you don't owe anyone an explanation. You don't have to justify its existence to anyone. You don't have to have anyone validate your truth but yourself, and that is the most validating thing in the world. Okay, so we're gonna finish off now with a gratitude message. I'm gonna move this out of the way, actually. But Spirit is saying, no matter what, either this person was brought into your life to help you see your higher purpose, or there's a higher purpose to this connection that involves your direct purpose, which totally a thing. Okay, so let's finish off, Spirit, with some guidance. What, Spirit, what advice do you have for pile four? When you walk through your home today, thank each and every corner of the space for its all silent witnessing of who you are. Praise, flow, and change, night and pulse of day. I'm gonna get this one too. Make a mental map of your life. Make a mental map of your path through life from infancy up through today, how far you have come. There is no satisfaction that can compare with looking back across the years and finding you've grown in self-control, judgment, generosity, and unselfishness. And I think that's where you're getting, and that's what you're healing. Like, you've come so far. There's so much to be grateful for. And I think you really have nothing to fear here. It's an illusion. And I think really what you're afraid of is maybe the bad things that happened in the past for some of you. But if that happened, you've healed from them and you're ready to face them. And I think you're tired of being in limbo with this situation. So at some point, things have to change, otherwise they won't. Who will? You know? And on the back of the deck, we have admire your own persistence, which you definitely have been, and you should be proud of that. If you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. And that's what Spirit is saying. Just keep moving forward. You are so lovable and so supported. And if somebody can't see your worth, then they're not worth your time. And you deserve somebody who can. Because somebody not seeing your worth is not an objective truth about your worth. It just means that they don't even see worth in themselves, so they can't see the worth in anyone else. Or they don't see worth in themselves, so they think they're not worthy enough for you. Which, the sad thing is that worth and value should be intrinsic as a human being. But not always seen that way. But pile four, I'm going to leave your reading here. Thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you so much for watching my ads. It's the simplest and easiest way to support me. I'm really sorry if this didn't give you more answers, but I'm honestly, I'm just channel, like, spirit took the wheel on this one. I really wasn't involved for very, like, my own mental logical brain wasn't very involved in it, in the whole process. So yeah, I don't know if it makes too much sense, but I hope at the very least it makes sense to the people who are watching it. I guess I just do want to say, like, I think sometimes I feel bad and feel guilty for talking about things like this, and I recognize that I'm doing nothing but alienating the people who need to hear this, who are going through this, because there's plenty of advice for people just dealing with regular shit. But these things are weird, and there's not always a place where you can get valuable information. And so I want everyone to feel welcome here. And unfortunately, you know, when it's open to everyone, sometimes not everyone will be able to resonate with the message, but sometimes it's important to just give the message that resonates with fewer people, because that's the guidance they truly need, and they may not get it elsewhere. So if you weren't satisfied with this reading, I would recommend either checking out a different pile or checking out someone else's reading. Maybe I just couldn't channel the messages for you, but yeah. Fuck, I'm like kind of scared to see how long this is, but yeah, I'm gonna leave this reading here, pile four. Big happy birthday to all of my Scorpios and all of my November Sagittarians. Thank you guys so much for watching all the way through and for letting me read your cards. If you would like to support me in other ways, you can check out my merch. You can check out my social media. You can like this video. You can comment down below. Let me know how it resonates. You can subscribe. You can do whatever you want. You can do nothing, but yeah, I'm wishing everyone a wonderful November. I hope that things go well, and I'm sending you all my love. I'm sure that things will go wonderfully. I trust you. Thank you so much for letting me read your cards. I think I already said that. I hope you all have a wonderful day or night, whenever it is that you're watching this reading, and I hope you'll come back and see me again soon. Bye!